Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy, and I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if it addressed concerns that people have. The list goes on about the.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day. Once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel...
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Russian intelligence officials offered cash incentives to Taliban militants in Afghanistan to kill US or UK troops.
President Trump was told about this in March, and he has done nothing.
He is so addled and mentally deficient that they didn't think it was worth their time telling him.
This is as bad as it gets. And yet the president will not confront the Russians on this score.
His entire presence has been a gift to Putin, but this is beyond the pale.
I think the more likely answer to this is some early intelligence, hasn't been verified, hasn't been vetted, and they're checking it out now. What if he acts on it and it turns out not to be true?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
A shooting overnight in Seattle's CHOP.
This is the second double shooting near the Capitol Hill-occupied protest zone known as CHOP in just about 8 days.
Two people were hit by gunfire around 3 this morning. One of the victims died.
Kids, you noticing all this flight? Roll them up.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
Do we know what this is? This is the mountain. This is the mountain that New Yorkers climb. You know, I keep showing the curve. This is the curve. It's actually proportionate. We don't want to climb this mountain again.
That is one big pile of shit.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The Democratic Party of Orange County wants to change the name of John Wayne Airport. A newly drafted resolution cites racist and bigoted statements made by the actor in a 1971 interview. It calls on the Board of Supervisors to restore the airport's original name, which was Orange County Airport.
Fill your hand, you son of a bitch!
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Welcome to the Howie Carr Show. I could just go off for a couple hours just on that intro alone. And I don't even think Taylor mentioned the Supreme Court decision by John Roberts, again, provided the decisive vote for the liberal majority. Yes, it is a liberal majority, apparently, on the Supreme Court. It's still not a conservative majority.
It's been a busy day, busy weekend. I can't fit everything into 2 minutes.
I understand. I understand, Taylor. That's not a complaint. I want to get it out there before people say I'm not talking about the Supreme Court decision. So 4 years ago, Roberts ruled in the minority, a 5-4 minority, on an abortion case. And he said that, the government had the right to, restrict abortion access or whatever. So today he votes with the other four liberals on the court. And as a reason, he cites that he has to go by the precedent that was set by the case where he was in the minority 4 years ago. I mean, how convoluted is this guy's thinking? He rewrote Obamacare so that it could become a tax rather than a fee or some such. I can't even keep it straight now. He spends all of his time trying to figure out excuses for why the liberals are right and the conservatives are wrong, or why the liberals can do what they want and the conservatives can't do what they want. Just like a couple of weeks ago, he said, well, you know, it's it's okay to end the Dreamers program for all the illegal aliens. But Trump didn't draw up the legal justification properly, so now he has to redraw the classification. Okay. But it was okay for Obama to make an unconstitutional executive order. Nobody said anything about that. Even Obama admitted it was unconstitutional, but he did it anyway. But they had to stop Trump from stopping the unconstitutional order. But again, as Taylor said, that's just one of the things we have to deal with. The thing that was really bugging me all weekend was this fake news in the New York Times about the Taliban bounty. The Taliban, the Russians were offering the Taliban a bounty for every American soldier that the Taliban killed. And I said to myself, okay, well, how many problems are there with this story? First of all, it's in the New York Times, the Bible of the Russian collusion hoax, and so many other things, so much other fake news, including the 1619 Project now. Then you have the problem of the Americans are pulling the troops out of Afghanistan. So why would the Russians want to upset the apple cart by making Donald Trump and the U.S. angry by setting up this bounty? Does the Taliban actually need a bounty to want to kill American troops? And they've reached this truce of sorts. And why do they want to upset the apple cart? Which they said in the statement. They said the Americans are leaving. We don't want to screw anything up. There have been two Americans killed this year in Afghanistan, and that's too many, obviously. But by way of contrast, there were 14 people killed in Chicago this weekend. Is there a big outcry about that, including three children, just gunned down? And guess what? The count by police shootings in Chicago, police deaths, police-related deaths of blacks, whites, anyone else, zero. So they said, well, he was either briefed on it, or he was briefed on it and he didn't care and he didn't read the briefing papers and all this. Do they think that every rumor that comes across the transom is it goes to the president's desk? You know, do they... The director of intelligence, Ratcliffe, the new director of intelligence, the former acting director, Rick Grenell, it didn't reach them, they said. So why would you think it reached the president of the United States? If you don't run with every unconfirmed rumor. I just got a tip today about a rather obnoxious local politician. And the double standards that he's exercising in the midst of the so-called lockdown. But that doesn't mean we're going to run with it tomorrow. We just started checking it out this afternoon, and we're going to try to make some more calls and figure out if it's true and see if we can bag him. And then that's just a hack story in Boston. Well, this is a story that has major geopolitical implications if it were true. And KT McFarland was on Fox today, and she said, "So you want the intelligence community to give him a report that's totally unconfirmed, that might be false, apparently is false." And what do you want, another weapons of mass destruction in Iraq type of situation here? And most importantly, does anyone think this is, couldn't this just be made up? Haven't they made up other stories in the past? Like he received, I know the one. I was trying to think of this all day. The Trump administration knew that there was coronavirus in China as recently as November. Remember that? That was a huge story for about 48 hours. And then it turned out it was totally false, that there was no intelligence report. They kept saying, well, where is the intelligence report? There was no intelligence report. And apparently, China didn't have anything in writing, at least, until a month later, after supposedly Donald Trump knew that coronavirus was here. So you remember that they said originally the Steele dossier was 100% correct. Then the Steele dossier was, some of it was correct. Well, Michael Cohen was his lawyer, after all. Then they said, well, some of it can be corroborated and some of it can't. And then they went back to the source of the Steele dossier. And he said, well, yeah, some of it, I was just passing it along as barroom talk. He was probably half in the bag. Steele was half in the bag. I don't know. But they, you know, he said it was barroom talk, like the hookers in Moscow. And then they asked him about some of the other stuff. And he said, I never told him that. So it was just totally fabricated. But I have a feeling this whole story was fabricated. Someone in intelligence just makes up a story and passes it on to the New York Times. The New York Times knows the only consequence of printing fake news about Donald Trump is you win a Pulitzer Prize. Doesn't matter if it's true or not, as long as everybody else picks it up and then they confirm it. I love how we've confirmed this. And then it turns out a couple of days later, a lot of these stories, they turn out to be false. Well, how did you confirm? How did the other Democrat stenographers confirm a fake story? 844-500-4242. There's so much more. And then all this violence, more deaths, another shooting in Seattle. Another double shooting in the CHOP zone. How's that summer of love working out for the mayor there? How's that block party working out? They need to set up a blood transfusion center and maybe an emergency ward, an ICU, an ER, and an ICU in the block party for all the people that are getting shot. 844-500-4242-508 says, interesting timing of this bounty story after Biden was busted on the Flynn fiasco. Yeah, it's funny how that always works out, isn't it? And I just can't believe that it just gets taken so seriously. I mean, the first I heard of it, I just said, more BS. I mean, the mainstream media has no credibility. What are they going to do when Trump is gone? I'm with O'Reilly on this one. They're gone. They're gone because who's gonna keep paying for this stuff? I mean, some people just like to hear the apocalyptic stories, Armageddon, this is the end of Trump, et cetera, et cetera. 844 anonymous sources, the old anonymous source. Is Colonel, where does Colonel Vindman have an alibi? As one of the texters just says, yeah. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here. The captain will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Route 1 Grill House in Saugus, located just before the Cactus. From their steak tips and ribs, the Route 1 Grill House has it all. Open now 7 days a week for both outdoor and indoor dining. Hey campers, this is Howie Carr. Camping season is here and Cold Springs RV is ready for you. If a new or pre-owned camper has been on your wish list, now is the time to check it off. Go see all the great specials at Cold Springs RV and score a deal on a pop-up, travel trailer, fifth wheel, or motorhome. Cold Springs is your destination for all things camping. If it is service you need, the brand new state-of-the-art service facility is ready for you, servicing all makes and brands. If your RV needs body work, whether it's a collision repair, roof replacement, or a new paint job, they have you covered. From minor repairs to major insurance jobs, Cold Springs RV can do it all. As a full-service RV dealer, you know they can fix just about anything. If it is time for your first RV or 10th RV, Cold Springs is ready for you. Cold Springs RV, your destination for all things camping. Route 114, Ware, New Hampshire. ColdSpringsRV.com.
He's the co-sponsor of the Green New Deal, so what better time to play some of his greatest hits? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Mr. Frosty.
This is going to be a mission to save all of creation.
If you want to ignore that these changes are taking place and that they're having a dramatic impact, then you are in the right place.
Do you know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock? Do you know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock, Senator?
Well, here is the thing.
You don't. How long has your family been in Massachusetts?
We are new arrivals, and
Mr. President, American history was made last night. The Boston Patriots won the Super Bowl.
When the Second Amendment was written in order to maintain a well-regulated militia, they did not have... People could purchase guns indiscriminately. The president is acting like Pontius Pilate.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
The coronavirus has made our lives unpredictable, but one thing you can always count on, the White House press corps will always ask President Trump ridiculous questions.
Question, Mr. President, should Americans have to decide between staying healthy and going back to work?
Hey, I was just checking on oil again today. I was wondering if...
Oil?
Yeah.
Where is it today?
Well, I was wondering if you...
No, where's the price? Give me the price.
I'm not sure, to be honest.
How can you ask a question when you don't know the price?
I'll look it up for you.
Okay, let me do somebody else.
What do you say the Americans were scared, though, I guess? Nearly 200 dead, 14,000 who are sick. Millions, as you witness, who are scared right now. What do you say to Americans who are watching you right now who are scared?
Well, where did he come from, the Inspector General? What's his name?
It came from the Inspector General.
No, what's his name?
I don't know his name.
Some of your allies have been bashing these doctors. Would you tell them to cut it out?
Today you tweeted, the invisible enemy will soon be in full retreat. Given it's invisible, without widespread testing, how would you know?
This is Jeff in Woodstock, Connecticut.
This is Laura Benner in South Burlington, Vermont.
This is Jimmy Mack in Falmouth, Massachusetts. And this is The Howie Carr Show.
Well, it's summer, as you know. It's kind of a rainy start to the Independence Day week, if you want to call it that. But it is summer. We were down on the Cape. We'll tell you about it later on. We had a great time this weekend. But there's also the islands. And you know the island, Nantucket and Martha's Vineyard. It's a great time to be down there. And last year we had a new sponsor, Southern Airways, and they were flying out of various places in New England to Nantucket. And it was great. It was very popular with our listeners, and we had a contest to give away. But so far, for the first part of the spring summer season, Southern Airways has been shut down by Mr. You-Know-Who. I refer, of course, to Charlie Parker.
Did this just happen?
Yes, the ban was just lifted or is being lifted. So joining us now is we're going to give away a pair of tickets to free tickets, round trip tickets to Nantucket from your choice of the airlines. We'll have Mark explain it. Mark Sesteri from Southern Airways. Thanks for being with us
again. Great to see you again, Howie.
It's great to see you, and I love that shirt. I was looking at my shirt this weekend. I have it. I'll still be wearing it soon this
great
weekend.
Dusted
but
off.
So tell us about what's been going on with Southern Airways.
Sure. Well, like so many businesses in New England,
our prime time is summer when the weather's good because the snowbirds like you come back. And unfortunately, this year, summer was slow in coming. We were supposed to start our New England service on April 16th, but for a variety of reasons, including the fact that the island was not really ready for tourists, we are finally launching our service on July the 2nd, this coming Thursday.
Excellent. Excellent. And where do people go if they want to if they want to get tickets?
Well, this year we're going to be flying from three cities, from Hyannis, Providence, and Norwood Airport. Parking is free at Norwood, and tickets are available at iFlySouthern.com, or they can buy on their favorite OTA.
Yeah, Norwood is an amazing place to get. It's so easy. Yeah. So easy. It's like going to Logan in 1973. You just pull, you know, except you don't have to put a dime in the meter because there's no meters.
Completely free.
Yeah. So this is the place to go. And so are the flights every day?
Yeah, we're daily this year. Hyannis is brand new. We did not fly there last year, but a lot of folks commute from Hyannis over to the island. A lot of folks that work on the island fly over to work, so we've added three flights a day from there. Providence, of course, is a very popular gateway for all Rhode Island and southeastern Mass.
Yeah.
And Norwood is the place we have to teach people about, but it's right off of 95. Parking is free. No TSA.
Yeah, and it's super close to Boston,
right,
especially with the reduced traffic. It's just if you don't go to Norwood very often, you don't realize how close it is.
Yeah. Well, all of our flights take less than 30 minutes. The interior of our aircraft is super roomy. You've been on it.
Yeah, I've been on it, and you fly fairly low, so it's just like a tourist flight. You go over those cranberry bogs. You go over the canal. It's just really cool. It's a nice flight.
And every seat is a window and an aisle. No middle seats on our airplane.
Okay, so here's how. So again, Southern Airways, they're back in business, flying to Nantucket on Thursday, starting Thursday from Hyannis, from Providence, and from Norwood, and it's a great experience. And we're going to give away two free tickets right now, but you got to answer a question. This is a trivia question. We went back and forth. We had some hard questions. We had some easy questions. So get on board now. 844-500-4242 if you want to win those tickets. 844-500-4242. And again, one of the questions we didn't use is, what was the first radio station on Nantucket? That seemed a little on the tough side.
Definitely.
To me. You know, and then we went with, what are the other two islands on Nantucket? And that seemed like doable. Did you know the answer to that one?
I knew one, but not two. So we ruled that one out.
I didn't know either one. So we ruled that one out too. So then we had one that's a little easier. It's a little easier for me because of my business that I'm in. But again, if you want a chance to win the tickets, 844-500-4242. Okay, now we're coming on. Now we're getting some people to come in. Yeah, I mean, you got nothing to lose and tickets to gain.
Absolutely.
People don't want to be embarrassed, but because we haven't done one of these telephone ones lately.
So what's the real question?
Well, the question is, well, we want to give it to the guy. We got our first caller. Carl, you're next with Howie Carr. You ready?
Yes, I am.
What is the name of Nantucket's weekly newspaper?
I have no idea. I'll call it the Nantucket.
No, that's not right. Thanks, Carl, though, for trying. Jim, you're next. What is the name of Nantucket's weekly newspaper?
The Nantucket Journal.
Paul, you're next. What is the name of Nantucket's weekly newspaper?
I'm going to go with Gazette.
That's better than the Journal, but still, it's not quite making it.
For the record, Howie thought this question was going to be too easy.
I did. I was going to make it, which member of the Kennedy family worked at this newspaper? We will now accept texts. We will now, the first texter is going to win. The first texter. At 63566. We'll announce the winner when we come back. I'm Howie Carr.
The last few months have been stressful for many, and it's time to do something for yourself. Recently, Grace reminded me of when I had that bad haircut 4 years ago. It was actually more like a buzz cut. Although it wasn't planned, I'm incredibly grateful to DiStefano Hair Restoration. Everyone was able to see that my hair could really grow back. I was annoyed when I couldn't get a haircut because of the shutdown, but I am happy that I at least have hair to cut once more. You can have the hair you've been thinking about for all these years. Dr. Hynes did a great job for me, and he will for you too. To learn more, go to hairman.com. You may have more time on your hands now, so take advantage of it and get the hair you've been wanting for years. People always stop me and say, it looks so natural. DiStefano Hair Restoration has 5 locations in New England and is open for business. For more information on location openings, go to hairman.com. Get the hair you've always wanted.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States Senate.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday.
I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by, you know the thing.
It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Chris.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920 and not 2020.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is your biggest issue is how are we going to pay for it? And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
Here's Donald Trump Jr. proving once and for all the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
They hate Trump more than they love America. For them to try to take a pandemic and seemingly hope that it comes here and kills millions of people so that they could end Donald Trump's streak of winning. I don't know if this is coronavirus or Trump derangement syndrome, but these people are infected badly.
To make this guy into a religious scholar, that's like saying Jeffrey Dahmer is a purveyor of organic and fine exotic meats. Adam Schiff is basically the Jussie Smollett of Congress on steroids.
Children are off limits. Remember this one? If 13-year-old Barron Trump is not off limits, Hunter Biden sure as is not off limits.
Because my name is Trump, if I took $1.5 from China, not $1.5 billion like Hunter, their heads would explode.
Who is your favorite Democrat? Go ahead.
Mitt Romney, Gail. Mitt Romney's my favorite Democrat. How about that? Please, Lord, in my next life, make me a leftist so I can say anything and get away with it.
live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Obviously, I overestimated the interest and the involvement people still have in the newspaper racket. But we finally got a winner on the text line. Who is it? Who'd we get there, Mark? Mark, I'm talking to Mark. Who'd we get, Taylor?
We got a guy by the name of 508.
508. He's
got it. We're going to be reaching out to him shortly.
Okay.
Or her. We don't know.
Yeah, and it's in a couple of people said the Inquirer or the Inky, but it's actually the Inquirer and Mirror. The Inquirer and Mirror. That's the winner. That's the weekly newspaper of the island of Nantucket. So that's the winner. So you got your winner there, Mark Sisteri. And again, this is a great service. Beats the hell out of the ferry.
We look forward to seeing you on board, Howie.
You will be seeing me on board. I guarantee it. Okay. Well, listen. Thank you very much. And again, thanks for coming in.
My pleasure.
For giving our listeners. And I'm glad. I'm sorry it took so long, but
we're up and running.
I'm glad you're back in business.
All right.
Thank you, Mark.
Great to see you.
Okay. Bye bye. Great to see you. 844-500-4242. And Douglas Kennedy was the member of the Kennedy clan who worked at the Inquirer and Mirror. He also worked at the Boston Herald. He worked at Fox News. I don't know if he still works at Fox News anymore. But he was a pretty good kid, actually. I won't say for the Kennedys, but he was a good kid. Let me put it that way. 844-500-4242. Skip the hassle at the grocery store and sign up to get delicious, high-quality meats delivered fresh right to your door at butcherbox.com/Howie. That's butcherbox.com/Howie. Taylor, how'd you like your birthday present of a Butcher Box?
I wish I had a birthday every week. It's really good stuff. And when I do get Butcher Box, I'll save it for when other people come over to my house. And I won't tell them what it is. And I won't put any seasoning on it either. I just cook it, grill it as is. And it always, always gets compliments. Yeah. And people want to know where it comes from. And I always tell them Butcher Box.
Yeah. If you order it, try the sausage. Order if you get the deal that doesn't include a pound of sausage, go for the pound of sausage. You're going to love it. It's great breakfast sausage. You can throw it in a meat sauce. It's really good. Not just spiced perfectly. Okay, but that's Butcher Box. What's the poll question, Taylor, and what are the results thus far?
Do bars pose any more of a threat of COVID-19 exposure than a trip to the supermarket?
See, the reason I mention this is because the Bar Owners Association in Texas, they were shut down on Friday, as you may recall. Again, after being reopened for a while, they're now suing in state and federal courts saying, why are we being singled out? And I'm going to say there's no more danger in a bar than in a supermarket.
61% think bars are as or more safe than a trip to the supermarket.
Yeah. Yeah. And incidentally, when are the free samples coming back at the supermarkets? Damn it. I'm, there've been so many excuses. For a while, they didn't give you your deposits back on bottles and cans. Now they have an excuse now they've cut hours in many cases. They haven't returned to the old hours. And we don't have any more samples anymore, anywhere. It's really bad.
I don't remember the last time I was offered a free sample at a supermarket.
Well, before COVID, there were plenty of samples at supermarkets before COVID.
When I was a kid, yeah, but I don't remember any of recent.
Are memory. You kidding? Boy, no. You went to the wrong supermarket.
I guess so.
That's all I can say.
Where have you been going? Just Market Basket?
Yeah, Market Basket, and then I go to I used to go to the little Valenti Farms.
Well, we just recently switched over to Market Basket from another retailer.
Market Basket used to have a huge, near the cold cut section where I went in Waltham, they had a huge counter, and that's all it was samples. I mean, you couldn't get one at 7 o'clock in the morning, but if you went at 11, they had plenty of samples, and there was always good stuff to eat. Publix, I used to go Publix in Palm Beach. They had a lot of samples too. All right. 844-500-4242, 561. You're a lot less likely to get drunk and sip beer on the floor of a supermarket. I don't think there's too much sipping of beer on the floor of bars, 561. 844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. I want to play some of these cuts from KT McFarland. And she was talking this morning on Fox and Friends. She used to be, in the national security apparatus at the White House. She worked for John Bolton, among others. And someone said, "Why didn't John Bolton mention this if it was such a big deal?" Well, Chuck Todd, another Democrat operative with a press pass, asked him about that yesterday on Meet the Press, and he just shot him down. He told him this was ridiculous. This, of course he didn't know about this. But anyway, cut number nine from Katie McFarland.
I was in the president's daily briefing every day when I worked for President Trump. Intelligence that gets to that level is stuff that's been verified, that it's been checked, it's been vetted.
Exactly. Go, keep going with that. Cut 10.
What this sounds like to me is early reports that maybe the Russians paid the Taliban to put a bounty on Americans, to kill Americans, to push Americans out of Afghanistan. I have a bunch of questions about the logic of that to start with. First of all, the Russians don't have a lot of extra dollars to put it anywhere. Secondly, the Russians hate the Taliban. And third, why give the Taliban money to kill Americans, to push Americans out, when the Americans are already leaving Afghanistan to start with?
Exactly. It's like going up to the sample desk at the supermarket and asking how much for this little piece of Vienna sausage or cheese. No, they're leaving anyway, so you don't have to pay anybody. Cut number 12.
For 3 years, the intelligence community, senior levels of the Obama intelligence community, fed to New York Times, Washington reporters, stories that had maybe a kernel of truth in it, but blew the rest out of proportion and fabricated it and made it into fake news. So for 3 years, we were chasing around this fake Russia hoax story, Russia collusion, Donald Trump is an agent of the Russians, Donald Trump is not tough on the Russians. Well, it turned out there was nothing to it.
Right. So
why is it the same reporters, the same right. intelligence community doing it again?
Yeah. For instance, Michael Cohen, that was one of the, well, you say there's no truth in the report. They say that Michael Cohen is the president's lawyer. Yes, he was the president's lawyer. He was in Otisville for a while at the federal lockup, and now he's been let go because of the panic. But it turns out that the rest of the story in the dossier was Michael Cohen went to Prague to talk with the Russians about the embargo and various other matters and payoffs, et cetera, on behalf of Trump. Well, guess what? It turns out, as Cohen said, you want to look at my passport? I've never been to Prague. It turns out there was a Michael Cohen from New York who went to Prague in 2016. He was an art dealer. He was not meeting with the Russians. He was buying some works for his gallery in New York City. And somehow, how would Steele come up with that? The fact that a Michael Cohen, his passport was being used to Michael Cohen's passport went to Prague. There's only, you wouldn't find that out from a Russian operative. You would find that out from from some U.S. intelligence. And that's what this was all about. That's where he got some of the stuff. 844-500-4242. 6069, this BS story about Russians paying the Taliban reminds me of the Russian hacking at the Vermont power plant. Yeah, that turned out to be that the Russians were hacking into the U.S. Eastern electrical grid to shut down the whole East Coast. Yeah, that turned out to be a guy checking his email, one of the workers at the power plant. Yeah, that was a big scoop by the Washington Post. Marty Baron, even the editor of the Washington Post, even put out a tweet saying, stand by for a major story.
This is so incredibly significant.
Yeah. Uh, 844-500-4242. 917. Thank God they got rid of the free samples. The senior citizens at Sam's Club would kill you to get their grape jelly on a cracker sample. And then another guy says, BJ's had lots of samples pre-COVID. You just were going to the wrong damn places, Taylor. You weren't going to the cheap supermarkets. You weren't going to the food clubs. What the hell? Were you?
My wife reminds me that we do shop in New Bedford, and free samples can be taken advantage of. Listen, I'm sorry. It's true.
They could be taken advantage of anywhere, Taylor. 844, as I know, and everybody who's texting in knows, 844-500-4242-917. These people don't understand how anything works. They all think the presidency works like it did on West Wing. Yeah, I know. It's just so ridiculous to see the insanity. I don't, Taylor's got some of the comments from the left wing media in the intro. It's not necessary to play them all again. But I just want to play one more. We had the other day, what was Nancy Pelosi calling George Floyd? What was the name she was using?
George, I forget. I'll find it.
Yeah. But anyway, so now it turns out that her counterpart in the Senate Minority Leader, Chuck Schumer, he also has a problem with the name George Floyd. Cut 14.
For the families of Floyd Taylor, or George Taylor.
George Kirby is what she called him.
That's right. That's right. At least George Kirby was somewhat of a celebrity at one point.
For the families of Floyd Taylor, or George Taylor.
Floyd the Barber. Sheriff Taylor.
Yeah, I know. I was thinking of that. He's somewhere in Mayberry, yeah. RFD land. Yeah. Is Barney Fife speaking into your ear, Senator Schumer? Katie, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Katie.
Nip it in the bud.
The bars. Hi, Howie. How are you?
How you doing? Good.
Good. Talking about the bars and the difference between the two, with the bars and the shopping. Shopping, we want to get the hell out, and we have to have a mask on. In the bar, I'm not wearing my mask. I want to get a drink and talk and be close. So, yeah, that's the big difference, and that's why you catch it faster, I think.
But if you're exposed to it, Katie, it doesn't mean you're going to die, does it? I mean, you get the flu and you recover. I mean, the average age among fatalities in Massachusetts has now gone back up to 82 again. It was down to 81 for a couple of weeks, but it just went up to 82 again over the weekend. And again, over 5,000 of the deaths, of the 8,000 deaths in Massachusetts, have come in nursing homes, not in bar rooms, not on airlines like Southern Airways, not in gyms. Not at driving ranges. It's preposterous that they would that they're dragging this thing out, and it's not a good thing to have these to have a small percentage of the population, these Karens, turned into mask police who are screaming and threatening people, and you have all these boards of health. I walked down the street in Chatham on Saturday. The mailroom manager was getting a massage. So she said, "You like Chatham, go take a walk." So I took a walk down the main street, and I noticed 80% of the people had masks on. I'm going, "What the hell's going on here? What happened to Chatham?" And then I see a sign on a telephone pole. It's a per order of the Board of Health. Ugh. I didn't, there were lines to get into the store, into the clothing stores. There were lines to get into, and you only could have so many people in. I ended up going to check out the Civil War monument of the town of Chatham. I think there were nine people killed in the Civil War.
How dare you?
One of them was named John Bolton, of all things. 844-500-4242. What's the number one sign of a bad home security system? A home security system that's so complicated that you never use it. This is exactly the type of security system Simply Safe has spent a decade fighting against. They believe that simple is safer, and it's exactly why Simply Safe is the home security for right now, when feeling safe at home has never been more important. Simply Safe was designed to be easy to use while protecting your whole home 24/7. Order online with the click of a button, open the box, place the sensors, plug it in, and your home is protected around the clock. No technician or salesperson has to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay an outrageous monthly fee or sign a two-year contract. When you have to worry about your security more than ever, but you still want to get out of the house just to get a weekend away, wherever you're going, if just to visit a relative or get down to the Cape or the islands for a weekend, you want to be sure that your house is safe in these perilous times. And that's where Simply Safe comes in. You know you've got protection 24/7 around the clock. And those are the calls that the police answer first, because Simply Safe doesn't have nearly the false alarms. It doesn't have any false alarms.
And Howie, I just want to let people know that in case you're really wondering, is it easy to install? Can I install it myself? I, Grace Curley, set up my own Simply Safe. So yes, you do not have to be a tech genius to set this up. It is very easy. They give you tons of instructions, and it doesn't take a long time at all, and then you feel so much better.
Simply Safe was named Best Overall Home Security of 2020 by U.S. News and World Report, and their 24/7 professional monitoring and emergency dispatch starts at 50 cents a day. 50 cents a day. That's a small price to pay for peace of mind. Head to SimplySafeHowie.com and get free shipping and a 60-day money-back guarantee. That's SimplySafeHowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr. We'll be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Follansbee Inn of North Sutton, New Hampshire. Just 90 minutes from Boston on the shores of pristine Kezar Lake. Perfect for year-round relaxation. Book your stay at FollansbeeInn.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer! Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great.
I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair.
For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie.
What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out?
Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
Joe Biden might be running for president in 2020, so we should play some of his greatest hits.
Barack and I finally reduced the disparity in sentencing, which we've been fighting to eliminate, in crack cocaine versus powder cocaine. Correct. It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double-barrel shotgun. If there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony, put that double-barrel shotgun, and fire two blasts.
They're going to put you all back in chains.
Give me a break. That's a bunch of malarkey.
The three-letter word. Jobs. J-O-B-S. Jobs.
One man stands ready to deliver change we desperately need. A man I'm proud to call my friend. A man who will be the next president of the United States, Barack America.
This is Chris in Rochester, Mass.
This is Mark in Nashville, New Hampshire.
This is Lorna in Truckstown, Pennsylvania. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
844-500-4242. 518. I was down on Jersey Shore last week. People were in bars and restaurants and all over the beach with no masks on, sitting right next to the signs from the New Jersey Board of Hacks Health, telling them to wear them at all times. It was so beautiful. 508, it's the same crap in Falmouth. Masks, beaches blocked with Jersey barriers, waiting lines at stores. I have had enough. I have had enough. Bruce from the Mets, he's in New Hampshire. Finally able to get my flat top haircut today, and they took my temp and gave me a mask to wear. I had to put the cover they put over you in a bin after. They raised the price $5 too. Total insanity, but I look good. Yeah. Well, I was looking at the Palm Beach paper today, and they're shutting the beaches from Friday to Sunday. Apparently the coronavirus is going to attack the beaches in Palm Beach County, particularly big over the weekend. Friday to Sunday. They'll be back open again on Monday. Oh, okay. Their excuse is, well, people from Broward and Miami-Dade will come up to our beaches if they're open, so we have to shut them down. So now they're not only discriminating against people that come in from out of state in all of these states, they're discriminating against people from county to county. So is Martin County cut off to people from Palm Beach County? How does it work? And Cuomo, we'll take a call here. Arthur, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Arthur.
Hey, thanks, Howie. Well, what do you bet that the LGBTQ clubs in Provincetown aren't being shut down?
I don't know the answer to that, Arthur. They never shut down the bathhouses during the AIDS. Or most places, I don't think, shut down the AIDS clubs during the time. And they had didn't they have a black transgender march in Brooklyn a couple of weekends ago, and nobody said anything then. And the New York City cops are resigning in the record numbers. Shootings have doubled in New York City. The shootings are up in Atlanta. They're up in Minneapolis. 14 dead in Chicago. I'm Howie Carr.
Over the past few weeks, we here at Matthews Brothers have come to realize some interesting things. For example, unless celebrities have a script in front of them, they really don't have much to say. Or, even those stuck in the lap of luxury can somehow manage to feel sorry for themselves. And mostly, we'll be happy if we never hear the song Imagine ever again, ever. In our 166-year history, Matthews Brothers has survived a number of epidemics, including scarlet fever, cholera, typhoid, measles, Spanish flu, Asian flu, diphtheria, polio, measles again, whooping cough, bird flu, swine flu, Ebola, Zika, and now COVID. Through it all and through them all, the men and women of Matthews Brothers stood side by side to keep their wicked awesome windows on their journey to builders, contractors, and homeowners all over New England. This time, of course, we stood 6 feet apart, but still, side by side. In a few short weeks, we'll be back to talking about baseball, apple pie, and which politician will be indicted next. But in the meantime, you can learn more about our wicked awesome main-made windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals, or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much. But no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gooner since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gooner is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black, and it's because of all the recycling that was going on, so I try to keep my taxes down that way.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
We all shop online, and now you can do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They lived with me. So they were my dogs. I love those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach about the age of 6 or 7. 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
You teachers who touched them, figuratively speaking, well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them, too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts.
I get in trouble some things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. If I'm your president, with me, it starts here in my gut, it goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight and then watch the hair come back up again. $1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
This is the Howie Carr Show, live from Chappaquiddick at the Party House, 25 years after Chappaquiddick 1969, on WHDH, News Talk 850.
Another bad song from 1969. 742-0850. We're going to take some calls this segment if you want to get on board. If you have any questions for John Farrar, the scuba diver who saw Mary Jo Kopechne's body underwater.
The number again, 742-0850. We're going to start talking about the incident and everyone's perceptions. John, let me just get this straight. So now, as far as your belief is that while Ted Kennedy was walking past all these houses back towards the party house where we're broadcasting from now, Mary Jo was still alive.
That is correct.
And she would have been alive probably for about an hour, you think?
I think that's most reasonable, and if an hour, if not longer, that's correct.
If not.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours, too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s, I was going down the stairs, and one of the kid's toys was on the stairs, and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up, and mishap.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Russian intelligence officials offered cash incentives to Taliban militants in Afghanistan to kill US or UK troops.
President Trump was told about this in March. And he has done nothing.
He is so addled and mentally deficient that they didn't think it was worth their time telling him.
This is as bad as it gets. And yet the president will not confront the Russians on this score.
His entire presidency has been a gift to Putin. But this is beyond the pale.
I think the more likely answer to this is some early intelligence, hasn't been verified, hasn't been vetted. And they're checking it out now. What if he acts on it and it turns out not to be true?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
A shooting overnight in Seattle's CHOP.
This is the second double shooting near the Capitol Hill occupied protest zone known as CHOP in just about 8 days.
Two people were hit by gunfire around 3 this morning. One of the victims died.
Kids, you noticing all this plight? Roll them up.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
You know what this is? This is the mountain. This is the mountain that New Yorkers climb. You know, I keep showing the curve. This is the curve. It's actually proportionate. We don't want to climb this mountain again.
That is one big pile of shit.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The Democratic Party of Orange County wants to change the name of John Wayne Airport. A newly drafted resolution cites racist and bigoted statements made by the actor in a 1971 interview. It calls on the Board of Supervisors to restore the airport's original name, which was Orange County Airport.
Fill your hand, you son of a bitch!
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
So they want to rename the San Diego airport because of the Playboy interview that John Wayne gave in 1971. Remember when the Playboy interview used to be a big deal? Not as big as the centerfold, but, you know, people said, oh, I'm buying the magazine for the Playboy interview. Now it's cost John Wayne, wherever he is, it's going to cost him the naming of his airport. But that's America. 2020 for you. Welcome to the Howie Carr Show. If you'd like to join us here at the beginning of the Independence Day week, and I'm going to call it Independence Day, not the 4th of July, because
That's what we're celebrating, is independence.
Amen.
From the reign, the monarchy of King George III. Many of us now live in states that where the governors think they are the king. They think they have as much absolute power as George III thought he had. And you know what? In many cases, they appear to be as mad, I mean, as in insane, as George III was in his latter years. But we'll get into that later. 844-500-4242, and Grace is here with the Grace's News.
Hello, everyone. I am here, and I want to start, Howie. There's a hero today.
Yes.
There's a White House press corps hero. We've talked about this phenomenon where now, to ask a question, you're not really looking for an answer if you're a journalist. You're looking to go viral on Twitter. You're looking for the blue checks to say, wow, that is, you are so brave.
Courageous.
You are courageous. You are speaking truth to power.
You have risked your something.
And then in the best case scenario, these people get kicked out of the White House, and then they can, all of the blue checks can gather around them and lift them up and say, this is not right. They need to, this is the freedom of speech. We are not the enemy of the people.
And then if you really score, the next person will have your back and ask the stupid question again.
And then also say, and by the way, I just want to say, Mr. President, I know so-and-so, and he is not a stone-cold loser. He is a very nice person. And we all go, okay, we'll take that into account. So today's hero is the one, the only, Ryan Lizza. We all know Ryan Lizza for a variety of reasons, of which I will not get into, because I don't want to upset you too early on in this segment. But wait until you hear the question that he asked.
He is the boyfriend of the woman who complained that, I think she basically said it was a war crime to keep them outside of a rally on a cold night in Iowa.
Oh.
Remember that?
Yes. So this is...
I forget her name.
Wait till you hear Ryan Lizza.
All their names are forgettable. So their bylines are even more forgettable. Their stories.
So he was talking to the White House. He was asking a question of the White House Press Secretary, Kayleigh McEnany. And this question is truly insane. Cut 16.
Does President Trump believe that it was a good thing that the South lost the Civil War? And then two, is he interested in following NASCAR's example and banning the Confederate flag at his own events?
Well, your first question is absolutely absurd. He's proud of the United States of America.
I just don't know where we're at that we have to ask these questions.
Ryan, are you a member of the party that seceded from the Union back in 1861, and that after the Civil War organized a paramilitary group known as the Ku Klux Klan to intimidate blacks and white Southerners who believe, and as they were known, scallywags Republicans? And are you a member of the party that promoted Jim Crow and the Dixiecrats and massive resistance and the segregationist movement of the 1960s? Are you a member of that party, Ryan?
Mr. President, are you glad that Adam and Eve took a bite out of the apple?
That is where their questions are at. They are ridiculous.
Right.
And now they're not even asking him. They're asking her, do you think the president would be happy about this? It's like, what? What world are we
in? Mr. President, do you think it was necessary for the Allied forces to storm the beaches of Normandy?
Be careful. Your answer will tell us a lot about you.
You know, and... this is the same media, not the same particular media outlet. What outlet is he with these
CNN,
days?
CNN, I believe.
CNN, okay. He's not with the Washington Post. The Washington Post, remember, is the one that somebody put together this goofy ad, and they said it was Fred Trump, Donald Trump's father. Remember this one? They said it was when he was running for mayor in 1969 in New York, he ran this ad. And... among other things, he never ran for mayor of New York in 1969 or any other year. So it was not, it obviously couldn't be his ad. It was I don't know, it was some kind of sick joke on the internet.
Was it fake news, perhaps?
It was fake news, but I mean, it is on a satirical site, but it became real news when I believe it was the fact checker for the Washington Post or the ombudsman. I think it was the fact checker, not the ombudsman, tweeted it out and said, look what has just been discovered. Look at the background of Donald Trump's father running these racist ads in New York City.
Well, you know what they say? democracy does die in darkness. So if we didn't have the fact checkers at the Washington Post, where would we be?
And of course, the Washington Post, they were the ones we mentioned at last hour, the famous story about the Russians trying to hack into the U.S. Electric grid on the East Coast in Vermont. And it turned out it was a guy who worked for the power company checking his emails.
Right.
But that was on the front page of the Washington Post. That was a major scoop.
A major bombshell, as they like to call it. Speaking of big news, Willie Nelson to headline Joe Biden's $100,000 per person virtual fundraiser.
How much does he owe now these days? Wasn't he about $25 million in arrears to the Internal Revenue Service?
So what's $100,000 to give to Joe Biden at this point, Willie? But wait till I tell you.
Can you, if you're the president, can you pardon somebody's debts?
Okay, so I am not a huge political contributor, so I am not aware of how these things work. But Howie, I would like to know. Normally, when you pay $100,000 to a candidate, you get to go to some sort of, you know, schmooze thing.
Yeah,
you get a free drink.
Yeah.
Maybe a scallop wrapped in bacon, perhaps.
Right. Exactly. And some nice kind of cheese. Not American cheese. Some kind of imported cheese.
For the guy out
Stinky
there who
cheese.
Makes the GIFs or the GIFs of our show, if you just saw how Howie's eyes lit up when I said scallops wrapped in bacon, we would like that as a gift. Thank you. So, Howie, this is not a gala or a gathering of any sort. This is a virtual event.
Right.
So even at a regular event, if you were with the people I'm about to name, the A-list of this party, you would need a few drinks under your belt. But this is virtual. This is like doing a Zoom call at work with these people. Okay, I'm going to list them for you. Julian Castro.
Okay, I can do without him.
Or as President Biden calls
Julian.
Him.
Julian Castro.
I thought Julio.
Oh, that's right. Julio. As in, me and Julio down by the schoolyard.
Failed presidential candidate, Beto O'Rourke.
I prefer to call him Robert Francis O'Rourke, his given name.
Former Planned Parenthood president, Cecile Richards. Now the party's just getting started. And the daughter of ex-Texas Governor Ann Richards. The supporters are expected to pay between...
Who was defeated by George W. Bush.
But I don't get what... I don't get how this works. Because doesn't there have to be some... Even if you're just giving money, you're giving money to sit on this virtual event? This sounds awful.
Ann Richards' daughter is an A-list celebrity among these people?
Well, at Joe Biden's virtual fundraiser happening tonight, yes, she is, Howard. Unless you would like to go, I'm sure you would rise to at least an A-.
Grace, surely it says how much Willie Nelson still owes. He can't have paid off the whole...
If you must dig deeper into this story, in November of 1990, the IRS seized nearly all of Nelson's property and assets, over 16.7 million in unpaid taxes. The Star took 3 years to settle with the taxing agency for $9 million.
$9 million. And now he's with the guy who wants to raise everybody's taxes and make everybody wear a mask.
I wonder if he's going to sing on the virtual event, or at least smoke a doobie.
That's true.
It seems like if you're paying to see Willie Nelson, you should get something out of it. Anyway, if you're thinking of replacing your carpets due to pet stains and odors, you must try Genesis 950 first. It breaks down the bonds of stains and odors so they're gone from carpets and padding for good. You know how this works. Your animal is going to have accidents. They're going to always probably have accidents. Even if you have the best animal in the world, they get old, they'll start having accidents. So order a gallon direct at genesis950.com. Enter code Howie to get more than $10 in savings. And I'm not just talking accidents, you know, they pee on the carpet, Howie. Some dogs get a little sick. They get a tummy ache. They throw up. You don't want to replace the whole carpet. You want to use this spray. It cleans it up. It takes away the smell, the odors. It's genesis950.com and enter code word Howie to get more than $10 in savings.
Works great. You need it. Saves you a lot of time, saves you a lot of effort, saves you a lot of money replacing those carpets and those pads. I'm Howie Carr.
You're tuned into the Howie Carr Radio Network.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by White Birch Brewing in Nashua, New Hampshire. Well known for their sours, heavily fruited sours, and IPAs. Stop in today and support a local family-owned business, White Birch Brewing.
Alexander Hamilton said, "Those who stand for nothing will fall for anything." This is Toby from Cape Gunworks. When our founding fathers drafted the Second Amendment, there was no question of its meaning. Today, if you have questions, come to Cape Gunworks for some advice, training, or to send a few rounds downrange. We have a fully stocked pro shop with a huge selection of guns, crossbows, archery, classes, rentals, a 15-lane range, and a friendly staff. Come on down to Cape Gunworks, Airport Road, Hyannis, or capegunworks.com.
Do you have no water, poor water quality, or low pressure? This is Howie Carr. Call the local water service experts, Skillings and Sons. They're ready with 24-hour service with no extra charge for after-hours calls. And a fleet of trucks stocked with parts to make sure you're not without water. With over 50 years of experience, they take pride in having a family of employees that are the best in the business. For all things water, Skillings and Sons is there for you. Skillingsandsons.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
We went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were two. Number one, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show, and for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a 2-year contract. You just order online. Set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
We went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were two. Number one, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
This is Karen from Billerica, Massachusetts.
This is Adrian in Swanton, Vermont.
This is Miss Susan up in Warner, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Social distancing and wearing masks, which I never do when I walk outside of this house. I never fail to do. Now, one day, on day one.
Wait, which is it, Mr. Vice President? You never go out with the mask, or you never go outside without the mask?
It sounds like Mad Libs, you know, when you're just filling in the words with other words. What was that for, Taylor? Was that an interview or was that a virtual town hall?
Yeah, he did some sort of a virtual town hall.
Did he do it on Saturday?
Q&As. I think it was yesterday.
He loves the weekend stuff. We're still going to find it, Joe. We're still going to play it over and over again.
But now now Schumer and Pelosi are trying to help him out by screwing up everything themselves.
Yeah.
They can't. Both of them got the name George Floyd wrong.
For the families of Floyd Taylor, of George Taylor.
These are the people that are trying to tell us they care so much.
Say right. Their name.
About about this issue. And they can't even get one name straight. It's
what were they thinking about for that 8 minutes and 46 seconds that they were down on their knees, except for Nadler, of course, because he couldn't get down.
They were thinking, I hope my Kente scarf stays on right. I hope this photo op goes over well.
I don't even think Floyd the Barber's name on the Andy Griffith Show was Floyd Taylor. That was it was Sheriff Taylor. It wasn't Floyd
right,
Taylor.
Right, he was conflating all kinds of Mayberry
right.
characters.
At least he didn't call him Otis. All right. Skip the hassle at the grocery store and sign up to get delicious, high-quality meat delivered fresh to your door at butcherbox.com/Howie. That's butcherbox.com/Howie. ButcherBox is the best, as we all know. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Do bars pose any more of a threat of COVID-19 exposure than a trip to the supermarket does?
The reason we asked this question is, as you know, the Texas bars were shut down after being open for maybe a month or so on Friday. And so they're going to file lawsuits in state and federal courts this week. And that's going to be their argument. Why is a bar any more terrible when it comes to passing on coronavirus than a supermarket? I say a bar is no worse than a supermarket.
62% agree with you.
I think what you hit on in the last hour, Howie, which is very true, is that a big part of this has to do with your age. If you're old, you shouldn't go to a bar, and you probably shouldn't go to a crowded supermarket. Mm-hmm. But the people who usually tend to go to bars are younger. Yeah. They skew younger. Their demo is kids who just got their license and want to go out and drink.
Well, bars should have a senior hour like the grocery stores.
Yeah, that's a really good idea.
And
4 o'clock.
And how about this? If you're really worried, stay inside.
Exactly.
If you're really worried, wear a mask. If you're really, really worried, wear gloves along with the mask and don't go outside.
It's personal responsibility and personal choice. And
right.
I think people prefer the government to tell everybody what to do instead of just deciding something on their own. But if you really feel scared, and that's okay, that's your right, stay inside.
You know, when I was in Chatham on Saturday down on the Cape, I might have gone in a store and like bought a new pair of Madras shorts, you know, because that's where I got my Madras shorts.
Like, yes.
COVID-19 saved us.
there's a nice bookstore down there where I used to sign books.
Yes.
I would have stopped in to see my friend there, but I didn't want to have a beef over the mask.
Yeah.
So I just stayed out.
Maybe we should get you a Madras mask.
No, I'm not wearing any kind of, it could be a gold-plated mask and I wouldn't wear it.
Well, speaking of rules that either to some people make sense, to some people they don't, this one makes sense to me. Las Vegas casinos could ditch cash amid coronavirus fears. So a lot of people think that, well, because money is so dirty, I mean, it's the dirtiest thing you could put your hands on. They're saying that people should be using their cell phones and, you know.
Yeah, but aren't a lot of people just into, they're going to do away with chips? I mean,
aren't
a lot of
slots.
People chips? Oh, coins.
Like quarters or pennies? I don't know how slots work.
You have to put a credit card in, like buying gasoline at a self-service location?
I guess cash isn't king anymore, but it used to be. Yeah, I don't know. Casinos have to be careful because they have a lot of,
What about strip clubs, Grace?
Strip clubs have figured it out. Strip clubs will have people drive by and they'll have the strippers outside dancing. And that way, no one gets
What
hurt.
About the $1 tradition
oh,
at strip
you're
clubs?
Right, they're
Come on,
tips.
Grace. Come on.
You know what they might have to give is like some sort of sanitary IOU. And you can stick that on the stripper. You know, IOU 5, IOU 10. Whether or not the people will actually pay at the end of the night, that's a different story. But I agree, there's going to be a lot of people who suffer. I mean, there's a lot of businesses that are cash only, sub shops, restaurants. You make a lot of money like that. So it's interesting. Now, we were talking about millions and billions of dollars that are being used towards this coronavirus stuff, but there's also a lot of cuts being made right now. Bill de Blasio confirms $1 billion cut from the NYPD budget.
Oh, that's a good response to the skyrocketing murder and just crime rate in general. This will help cut down on the illegal fireworks in the city. I'm Howie Carr.
Is going on now. Embrace the great outdoors in a brand new 2020 Subaru Forester, a 2020 IIHS Top Safety Pit Plus. Lease for only $265 per month for 36 months with $2465 due at signing. Powered by standard symmetrical all-wheel drive, the Forester is equipped for your summertime excursion. For complete details, visit SubaruofNewEngland.com.
Come back to Cape Cod at the only lodging inside the Cape Cod National Seashore, the Nauset Beach Inn, a place where you can sleep to the sounds of breaking surf at a price you can afford. The Nauset Beach Inn rooms are equipped with two queen beds, coffee makers, microwave, refrigerator, fireplace, barbecue on the grounds, and you can bring your dog. A one-of-a-kind hotel with a path to the beach just outside your room. That's NausetBeachInn.com. An ocean view from every room at a price you can afford.
Here's 1 minute of Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
There's a lot of restaurants that are feeling the pain of racism, where people are literally not patroning Chinese restaurants. They're not patroning Asian restaurants because of just straight up racism around the coronavirus. So,
you know, only in America does the president, when the president tweets about liberation, does he mean go back to work? When we, you know, have this discussion about going back or reopening, I think a lot of people should just say no. We're not going back to that.
One of the, I know it sounds banal. Do we know how long puppies are allowed to stay with their mothers after a dog has given birth?
I don't.
8 weeks. Wow. So the market has decided that women and people who give birth deserve less time with their children than a dog.
So the whole premise of the Green New Deal is that we're screwed.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day. Once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
You teachers who touch them, figuratively speaking, well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts,
I get in trouble some of the things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. If I'm your president, with me, it starts here in my gut, goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight and then watch the hair come back up again. $1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They live with me. So they were my dogs. I love those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach, about the age of 6 or 7, 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. We're joined now, as we are most Monday afternoons at this time, by Joe DiGenova, the former U.S. attorney, to discuss Russiagate and other issues as well. Joe, thanks for being with us. First, before we talk about the latest developments in Obamagate, Russiagate, I'd like to ask you about John Roberts, the Chief Justice of the U.S. Supreme Court. What has happened to that guy?
Well, John Roberts has always been a strange duck, and inevitably he has never been the conservative like a Scalia or a Clarence Thomas that we would have hoped. And what he has done is his entire history is defined by his decision when the Obamacare case came before the Supreme Court, and he was part of a 5-4 majority to strike it down as an unconstitutional usurpation. And he changed his vote at the very last minute.
Right.
And you could tell by the way the opinion was written.
Right. They didn't even change have time to change the text.
That is correct. He changed his vote because of public pressure from the Obama administration condemning them and from congressional Democrats who warned them. And the Democrats did the same thing recently where they threatened the court.
Sheldon Whitehouse from Rhode Island.
That is correct.
A former U.S. attorney, by the way, like you.
Yes, unfortunately. Some of our alumnus are a little weird. So Roberts is now, he's kind of the dirty cop of the Supreme Court. This is why it was so important for Trump to be able to replace Ruth Bader Ginsburg, because that would have ensured a solid 5 of conservatives with Roberts being this weird 6th guy, because he clearly is not a conservative anymore. He's now an institutionalist, and he believes it's his job to, quote, save the court. And the abortion case today is the best example of that.
Today he voted the opposite way that he voted 4 years ago on a Texas abortion law, and he was on the minority side then, and he thought it was the wrong decision. So today he said, I have to vote against Louisiana because that's the statutory that's precedent. Right. So he didn't think the vote was right 4 years ago, but now he voted to uphold the precedent that was set 4 years ago. That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Well, you know, these guys are used to, you know, doing stuff that looks weird and unconventional. And in his mind, I'm sure he's happy as a clam that he's done the right thing and that he is being consistent. But it's of no moment. I mean, really, this the issue of abortion is what it has always been. It was created by a Republican justice, Harry Blackmun, one of the Minnesota twins. Everybody thought they were going to be conservatives. They ended up being monstrously liberal in many ways. Blackmun certainly did. And Blackmun changed politics forever with Roe v. Wade. And no matter what your position is on abortion, when he decided to change the law and make abortion a constitutional right, which was completely inconsistent with the common law at the time of the Constitution being adopted, there were laws against abortion in every state and in every commonwealth. But he decided, Blackmun, that he was going to, you know, he's going to change the law. And he changed American politics forever by doing it, and gave us presidents, gave us, you know, Reagan and others, and kept a political issue alive, which is still alive today.
Right, which was being resolved in the individual states through the legislatures.
Yes, through the political process, and some states were allowing it, other states were not. And he steps in like Bigfoot and just decides this is a new constitutional right, which he created out of the ephemera of the penumbras around the
Good
first
words.
And the fifth and the 14th.
Right. Exactly. Let's talk about the latest from Sidney Powell. She said an amazing thing on a talk show interview over the weekend. She said that Flynn, we knew he was planning an audit of all the intelligence agencies. This is Sidney Powell, the lawyer for Michael Flynn, who was convicted under these this ridiculous frame up by the FBI and the Department of Justice and fired as national security advisor. She said that he was planning when he got into the White House to run an audit of all the intelligence agencies' books. And she said he was particularly interested in John Brennan, the head of the CIA, because he was spending billions, not millions, billions of dollars off the books. Were you surprised? Right. I think we'd all suspected this. Were you surprised to see her say it that directly?
No, because Sidney is a very direct and blunt person, and she has done so remarkably in this case involving General Flynn. And I think what's clear is that Brennan knew that, Obama knew that, Biden knew that, Sally Yates knew that, Comey, and they decided they were going to destroy General Flynn. And it is every day that I get up and think about the Flynn case, my heart goes out to the man and his family. But they're going to survive this no matter what this nut Emmett Sullivan does in this case, because General Flynn is a strong human being who served his country courageously for 30 years. And he knew that there was a stench in the intelligence community. And Brennan proved it after the election by everything that he did. He declared war on a sitting president. He declared war on a candidate. He declared war in an interregnum between election and inauguration. John Brennan is the embodiment of the evil that has become part of the political part of the CIA. And I must say, I try not to hate people because it doesn't do any good. It consumes you. But I really hate John Brennan. I think the guy is the most despicable. What he's done to the reputation of the intelligence community by his public performance, it's like Comey and the FBI. You know, you can't, if you're going to save these institutions, people like Brennan and Comey have to go away, but they just won't go away. And they are harming the agencies that they once led because people now remember how evil and how bad these people were.
You know, the thing is, Joe, if Brennan had any successes, if he had the record of, say, Wild Bill Donovan, you know, who ran the OSS, which was the precursor of the CIA. I mean, this guy was fantastically successful in knocking down Nazi sabotage rings and helping win World War II. But what the hell did Brennan ever do? The guy was a total screw up, wasn't he?
Oh, listen. He spied on a president of the United States, his own president. You know, when the FBI scandal started on July 5th, 2016, when Comey gave his famous exoneration of Hillary, I wrote down a line that I used in my first speech, and this is how it started. The FBI used to spy on the Russians. This time, they spied on us. And I'll tell you something. That line has gotten stronger and stronger as we now know how much Brennan did to corrupt the intelligence process, both in the United States and overseas. Brennan has no accomplishments. He has nothing but failures from Libya to Syria, you name it, across the board in the Middle East and elsewhere around the world. Brennan was a failure because Brennan was corrupt. And, you know, if you're the head of the CIA, of course you want to be able to cut the corners necessary to protect the American people. You want to be, when it's necessary, you have to do what you got to do. But the problem was, Brennan did it to Americans and to the United States government and our political process and to a president of the United States. Brennan was like Castro twice, you know, double.
And you know, I keep thinking how much money Stefan Halper got. And that, a lot of that money came from the Pentagon. But, I mean, this guy, Stefan Halper, he's like some big, fat, 70-year-old guy with a nose like a pickle who hangs around cocktail parties in Oxford. And they were paying him hundreds of, probably millions of dollars, right? What? And then when I read that
over the years.
Go ahead.
Over the years, Halper has gotten just untold sums of money from the Defense Department in its Office of National Assessment. And it is believed that one of the places that the leak of the Flynn-Kislyak call could have come from was that organization that Halper worked for. Halper is, you know, he's a person whose role will be defined, I'm sure, ultimately by the Durham report after Durham brings his indictments. I'm sure we'll learn a lot more about Halper and all of that. Mm-hmm. But I'll tell you, thank God we have Bill Barr here so that.
But how many Halpers were there? And I mean, and was the money just going to people like that and Joseph Mifsud, or was it going for even more nefarious stuff?
Well, I think it's pretty clear that there was domestic spying going on in the United States that they did not need Halper and Mifsud and people like that for. And the Israeli spy, I think his name was Tawil, who gave Papadopoulos the $10,000 cash in the hopes that he would bring it back into the United States and not declare it. The untold story, though, that is yet to come is the massive spying on American citizens that went on by FBI contractors under the direction of James Comey and Brennan using NSA databases starting in 2014. That's the big scandal here besides the spying on President Trump. And the press wants nothing to do with it, even though the FISA court has numerous opinions outlining the huge degree of illegal activity conducted by the FBI.
Any closer to a resolution of the Flynn case, a final resolution?
Well, it looks like the never-to-be-understood Judge Sullivan is contemplating waiting to see if the judges on the circuit are going to seek a rehearing in bank. He does not have the right to seek a rehearing in bank.
That means the whole court, not just the three-judge panel.
Yeah, the full court.
Yeah.
Now, it may be the Judge Wilkson who wrote that dissent and who asked those racially charged questions during the oral argument will try to convince four of his colleagues to go for, or a majority of his colleagues, for a rehearing. But I think the court is smarter than that. This case will be resolved, I would hope, by the ruling that was issued. But Judge Sullivan, I think, is a little crazy right now. I think he's lost it. I think his demeanor on the bench and his statements have been very disturbing and extremely disappointing for a federal judge. So God only knows what he's got in mind.
All right, Joe DeGeneva, happy Independence Day, if I don't talk to you again before then.
You bet, Howie. Thanks.
Everyone needs a great pair of wireless earbuds right now, and you already know that Raycon earbuds start at about half the price of every other premium wireless earbuds on the market, and that they sound just as amazing as other top audio brands that you know. Their newest model, the Everyday E25 earbuds, are their best ones yet. Mine just came out here. With 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a nice noise-isolating fit. Raycon's wireless earbuds are so comfortable, perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. They're the best. And, you know, if you're still cooped up, if you're in one of the states that's still on a lockdown, modified or re-instituted lockdowns, and you're spending a little too much time with your significant others or your roommates, and you need a break from their entertainment, their music, their podcasts, Raycons are the way to go. And again, they're so much cheaper, and the quality is just as good, if not better, than the more expensive models.
And Howie, I know you got McKay, your Florida assistant, a pair of Raycons as a thank you.
Yes.
And I just wanted to let you know, he texted me and said, Let Howie know the Raycons are awesome, really great audio sound, and the phone call quality is amazing.
That's good. I'm glad McKay is enjoying them, and so is Grace. We give them out as a birthday present to everybody who works for us now because they're so good. And they're affordable. Unlike some of your other wireless options, Raycon earbuds are both stylish and discreet with no dangling wires or stems. You've heard me talk often about how the company was co-founded by Ray J, and celebrities like J.R. Smith are obsessed with Raycons. Now's the time for you to see what the hype is all about. And here's a chance to save even more money. Get 15% off your order today at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie for 15% off your Raycon wireless earbuds. Buyraycon.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Radio Network.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Moby Dix on Route 6 in Wellfleet. Don't let the lines deter you. It's worth the wait. From seafood gumbo to lobster rolls, Moby Dix has it all.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's why I'm saying I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon started about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever. And VB was always saying that we were whipped, if you know what I mean. Finally, I said, you don't even have a girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear?
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020, and that some horrible Democrat will come in and finish off the destruction of this once great country.
Out of all of your daughters, who is the least like you and why?
Probably Charlotte, even though we went to the same high school, Deerfield Academy. She has a different sense of her responsibilities than I do. Let me put it that way. She has a different regard for money. She's not a cheap bastard, in other words.
Hi, this is John in the People's Republic of Amherst, Massachusetts.
This is Heather from Litchfield, Maine.
This is Kent, Wichita, Kansas, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
People have watched me on television, and they've watched, and the more that Donald Trump is out.
What are you running for, Senator? Or are you in Congress? Do you remember when he said he was in Congress in 1970? He was actually on the city council in Wilmington. Yikes. 844-500-4242 if you're interested in reading any history books instead of watching Netflix at night during this time. You might there's some good books about the founding of the CIA, how it went from the OSS to the CIA, and J. Edgar Hoover tried to stop it, and supposedly they got J. Edgar Hoover off their backs with some photographs that apparently Meyer Lansky had a hand in it too, the gangster who would work with the OSS, I guess, during the during World War II, on the docks in New York. Meyer Lansky was Lucky Luciano's guy. It's a very complicated, convoluted story, but it's very interesting if you're interested in U.S. intelligence, organized crime, politics, all those years and plots and schemes and counter schemes. Check it out. Patrick, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Patrick.
Howie, thank you for taking my call. I'm a conservative Trump supporter in Oklahoma. My question is this. Richard Grenell was the first one I ever heard suggest this, and I wonder if this is possible to start to break up the Blue Beltway in Washington, D.C., speaking of their statehood drive and all that. Is it possible or feasible to break up the bureaucracy in Washington, D.C., and move the institutions out of middle America?
Trump suggest that in his first year in office? I think he was talking about moving the Department of Agriculture out to the Midwest, maybe Kansas, not Oklahoma, but maybe Kansas or somewhere. Don't you remember all the economists at the Department of Agriculture? They all had a collective heart attack when it was suggested that they move out to actually where the people they serve live.
Well, it's amazing because we're never going to get rid of the size of government, but we could make better use of government and labor and bring the thought to the Midwest to the different departments.
I agree, but it's really difficult. Look at Ronald Reagan tried to get rid of the Department of Education and the Department of Energy. He said, what have they ever produced in the form of energy? Has education ever helped any child learn the Department of Education? Of course they haven't. You know, I was surprised that President Trump won a victory today over what is the Consumer Protection Finance Board. That's the agency that Elizabeth Warren set up, and it was it sort of operated as a fifth or fourth branch of government. It took all of its money. It didn't have to rely on an appropriation from Congress. And the Supreme Court finally gave President Trump, as was expected, the right to fire the head of the Consumer Finance Protection Board. And that was a great hack dumping ground for Washington. They had all these secretaries that were related to generals at the Pentagon and connected to congressmen. They were all making, even the secretaries were making $150,000. But now Trump's got control of it. So I guess it'll be different people making $150,000. Thanks for the call, Patrick. I'm Howie Carr.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
It's time for quarantine questions. You're up, Jared. What have you been eating the most during this quarantine?
I've been eating a lot of Indian food because that's all that's in the machine downstairs, and I'm really growing to like it.
What is your drink of choice during the lockdown?
My drink of choice, I'm definitely a scotch guy. A nice Dewar's really does it for me.
What about a non-alcoholic drink?
Coffee.
What one TV show would you recommend to people who are quarantining right now?
One show? Star Trek: The Next Generation. You can't go wrong. It's got everything you want. It's got high concept science fiction. It's got humanity. It's got great characters. It's the last truly great television show.
What is the biggest pet peeve about being at home?
I can see all the dirt that I don't clean, and it mocks me.
What is the biggest silver lining of staying at home?
I'd say wearing sweatpants, but I do that most of the time anyway. I'll say wearing my Spider-Man costume and not being judged.
What's one book you're loving right now?
I'm a big comic book guy, so I'm reading a lot of comic books. Right now, I'm going back over the classic Stan Lee, Steve Ditko, Amazing Spider-Man run, about the first 40 issues.
Howie says it all the time, when it comes to bad politicians, Massachusetts takes the cake.
It is my honor to introduce to you your senator, my senator, Senator Elizabeth Warren.
I know who I am because of what my mother and my father told me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Governor Deval Patrick.
And frankly, I got to tell you, with all the other things I'm worrying about, this is not one of them. We're going to be fine. I'm in charge.
Please join me in welcoming our own Senator Ed Markey.
The planet is running a fever. There are no emergency rooms for planets.
The very first African-American congresswoman to be elected from Massachusetts, Ayanna Pressley.
We don't need any more brown faces that don't want to be a brown voice. We don't need black faces that don't want to be a black voice. We don't need Muslims that don't want to be a Muslim voice. We don't need queers that don't want to be a queer voice.
Let's give them a great Waterloo reception. God, Perry.
The Yankees posted the Boston Red Sox logo and they sang Sweet Adeline.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If Mr. Gunnar was a person, what college would she attend?
The U.S. Coast Guard Academy.
Is Mr. Gunnar a conservative or a Democrat?
Mr. Gunnar is a fiscal conservative and a social liberal.
If you could have dinner with any president, dead or alive, who would it be?
Calvin Coolidge. He was from Massachusetts, and I liked his attitude towards public sector unions, and he said the business of America is business. He's my guy.
Other than yourself, which columnist do you respect the most?
The late George Frazier. He was a columnist for the Boston Herald, the Boston Globe. Most people have forgotten him now. Jimmy Cannon was pretty good. He was so good that Mike Barnicle used to steal stuff from him all the time. Breslin was good in his early days, not so good later on, but when he was working for the Herald Tribune, back when I was a kid in New York, he was damn good.
It's time for quarantine questions. You're up, Jared. What have you been eating the most during this quarantine?
I've been eating a lot of Indian food because that's all that's in the machine downstairs, and I'm really growing to like it.
What is your drink of choice during the lockdown?
My drink of choice, I'm definitely a scotch guy. A nice Dewar's really does it for me.
What about a non-alcoholic drink?
Coffee.
What one TV show would you recommend to people who are quarantining right now?
One show? Star Trek The Next Generation. You can't go wrong. It's got everything you want. It's got high concept science fiction. It's got humanity. It's got great characters. It's the last truly great television show.
What is the biggest pet peeve about being at home?
I can see all the dirt that I don't clean, and it mocks me.
What is the biggest silver lining of staying at home?
I'd say wearing sweatpants, but I do that most of the time anyway. I'll say wearing my Spider-Man costume and not being judged.
What's one book you're loving right now?
I'm a big comic book guy, so I'm reading a lot of comic books. Right now, I'm going back over the classic Stan Lee, Steve Ditko, Amazing Spider-Man run, about the first 40 issues.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show. And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s, I was going down the stairs, and one of the kid's toys was on the stairs, and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up, and I still have a bridge, a crown, from that mishap. I have a replacement hip, and now I have a bunch of pins in my left elbow.
When do you plan to retire?
I don't plan on retiring. As an old football coach once said, once you retire, there's only one big moment left. You know what that is.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now, when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie.
What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out?
Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Out of all of your books, which is your favorite title and why?
I think my favorite title is Hitman because it's very effective. I thought long and hard about it. We're going to make it Boston Hitman, but then why make it Boston Hitman? Just make it Hitman. Make it a universal subject.
If you could have dinner with one author, dead or alive, who would it be?
I would probably have dinner with William Shakespeare. I know that's a cliche response, but he was the greatest writer in the English language, no question about it.
If you won Mega Millions, would you retire completely?
I used to say no.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Russian intelligence officials offered cash incentives to Taliban militants in Afghanistan to kill U.S. or U.K. troops.
President Trump was told about this in March, and he has done nothing.
He is so addled and mentally deficient that they didn't think it was worth their time telling him.
This is as bad as it gets. And yet the president will not confront the Russians on this score.
His entire presence has been a gift to Putin, but this is beyond the pale.
I think the more likely answer to this is some early intelligence, hasn't been verified, hasn't been vetted, and they're checking it out now. What if he acts on it and it turns out not to be true?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
A shooting overnight in Seattle's CHOP.
This is the second double shooting near the Capitol Hill-occupied protest zone known as CHOP in just about 8 days.
Two people were hit by gunfire around 3 this morning. One of the victims died.
Kids, you noticing all this flight? Roll them up.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
You know what this is? This is the mountain. This is the mountain that New Yorkers climb. You know, I keep showing the curve. This is the curve. It's actually proportionate. We don't want to climb this mountain again.
That is one big pile of shit.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The Democratic Party of Orange County wants to change the name of John Wayne Airport. A newly drafted resolution cites racist and bigoted statements made by the actor in a 1971 interview. It calls on the Board of Supervisors to restore the airport's original name, which was Orange County Airport.
Fill your hand, you son of a bitch!
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
A gift to Putin, says Joe Biden. What about Barack Hussein Obama refusing to arm Ukraine when they were being invaded, when they doing nothing, when they took Crimea? How about shutting down fracking in the U.S. so that the world would be more dependent on Russian exports of energy? The fact that the U.S. is now the world's leading producer of energy under Donald Trump because of the fracking boom has really put a crimp in Russia's economy, hasn't it? How about the fact that we armed Ukraine under Donald Trump? We didn't send them blankets and socks. We sent them anti-tank weapons. How about the fact that the U.S. Attacked Russian mercenaries in Syria, killed several hundred of them? How about the fact that Barack Obama told the told one of the top Kremlin operatives, tell Vladimir that after I'm reelected, I'll have more flexibility? I mean, is that a gift to Putin? How about that stupid Russian reset button? How about backing off from our plan to or our threat by Obama to take out the Russian puppet ally Assad in Syria? Remember the red line, and he backed off, and he allowed the chaos and the civil war in Syria, which then destabilized Europe with millions of migrants seeking to escape the violence. How about all that? But hey, that's nothing to see. We got to talk about the phony story about Trump supposedly standing by when the Russians were paying off the Taliban. Total BS. Total fake news. All right, time now for the Chump Line.
Hey, Howie, does the Cheap Bastard deal have any free samples?
No, not right now. We used to give away magnets, but we're fresh out of magnets. So because of the COVID-19 panic, we've shut down the free samples at the Howie Carr Show store. But you can still get great buys there. Go to howiecarshow.com and click on store, and you can find lots of stuff. 603 says, was Barry an asset of Iran after five plane loads of cash? After what, $150 billion we released to Iran? The world's leading sponsor, state sponsored terrorism. Were we an asset of them? And what is Iran's biggest ally? I believe it's Russia.
Howard Carr, master sampler of the free sample.
I am. I used to love to go down to Market Basket in the morning on Sunday morning, and then after I got back from Market Basket, I would drive over to Valenti Farms and have some samples over there. I didn't have to eat all day between Market Basket and Valenti Farms. It's all over now. I don't like the new normal when there are no free samples. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer, and believe it or not, was actually started by three actual brothers: Spencer Walcott Matthews, Noah Merrill Matthews, and Sanford Hills Matthews. They were real people who made real contributions to their community. We're proud to brand our windows with their names.
Jeremiah, everyone's talking about a second wave now. RM, I thought the second wave was when I dove back into the water to save Mary Jo.
That too.
I thought alcohol killed the virus.
No, did you hear they've come up with a cure for COVID-19, Taylor?
And what might that be?
It's a riot.
That's right.
I heard that joke on Cape Cod over the weekend.
If it's okay to take down and remove ancient relics from our past, let's go after Pelosi.
Hey, listen, she's a very great supporter of the memory of George Kirby, as she calls him.
So New England has signed quarterback Cam Newton. Are the fans excited? You're darn tootin'. They were all boo-hoo. Now it's Tom who? And when the Pats play the Bucks, he'll be as Hitler is Putin.
Did you see Richard Sherman? I think he plays for the Seahawks. He's from Stanford University. He's a defensive back. He was shocked that Cam Newton had been signed for the minimum, making it sound like it was another Colin Kaepernick deal. But nobody else wanted to sign him because he was making too much money and they were unsure about his health. So that's why the Patriots got a good deal on him and paid him the minimum for a year. And he has incentives that'll pay him up to $8.5 million. It's kind of hard to say that's a bad deal, isn't it?
Wow, so the world's biggest pothead is going to head Biden's potluck dinner.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. I think the pot has affected Willie's brain a little bit. You know, he's like 85 years old to begin with, and I don't think smoking that kind of weed every day for, I don't know, a half century is really that good for your cognitive faculties.
I think they're doing a fundraiser with him to make Joe Biden appear less addled than by comparison.
It's the NCM fundraiser, non compos mentis.
Russia, Russia, Russia.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. They're like a dog with a bone, you know? And you know, the dog gnaws on the bone for days, and you know, then he forgets about it for a couple of days, and then he goes out and he sees the bone. There's nothing on it, but he just starts chawing and gnawing on it again. That's what these people are like.
Hi, Howie. Governor Patrick calling. Wow, no problem in those sports this year. I guess Massachusetts students will be living the Howie Carr experience. We're going to be fine.
I beg your pardon. I was a New England champion, not the Massachusetts champions. I was a member of the New England champion bridge squad of 1969.
Mr. Sherman, this is Bonnie Fife. What are you doing? Confusing everybody with what's going on. The guy's name was George Floyd, not Floyd the Barber or Andrew Floyd or whatever the hell you're saying.
That guy is good.
That was damn good.
That was superb.
I thought Don Knotts was on the phone.
Let's listen to Schumer again, what Don Knotts was commenting in The Great Beyond. Cut 14.
For the families of Floyd Taylor, George Taylor.
Floyd the Barber? Otis? Aunt B? Somebody.
People who live in CHOP or in Chicago should think about moving to Afghanistan. It's safer there.
Yeah, how about New York? New York had a bad weekend as well. And how about the St. Louis? Did you see the picture of those two lawyers? Out in front of their house, this mob was headed for the mayor's house in St. Louis. It's a private gated community, so they were trespassing. And this couple, personal injury lawyers, came out, and the woman had a handgun, and the husband had a rifle. No charges filed. They had every right to be out there. They were concerned, and who can blame them?
With two additional shootings in Seattle, would it be fair to say that things are choppy?
Hey, it's the summer of love. Didn't you hear what the mayor said? Mayor Durkin. Do you believe it? She's a former prosecutor, and she's this clueless about crime. Of course, I guess Amy Klobuchar and Kamala Harris are former prosecutors too, and they're kind of clueless themselves, aren't they?
That was your last chump line message. Thank you for calling Howie Carr, you chump.
All right, that's it for the Chump Line today. The Chump Line is the recorded voicemail message service of the Howie Carr Show. You can call and leave a message at any hour of the day or night, including weekends. The Chump Line number, if you'd like to leave such a message, is 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. Press 2, leave your message. We may or may not play it at this time each weekday. If you didn't hear your message or you want to hear more Chump Line messages, just wait a couple of hours when we post Chopped Chumps right after the broadcast show ends. where get them, get Chop Chumps wherever you get your Howie Carr Show podcasts. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. And believe it or not, it was actually started by three actual brothers, Spencer Walcott Matthews, Noah Merrill Matthews, and Sanford Hills Matthews. They were real people who made real contributions to their community. We're proud to brand our windows with their names.
Mr. Schumer, this is Bonnie Fife. What are you doing? Confusing everybody with what's going on. The guy's name was George Floyd, not Floyd the Barber or Andrew Floyd or whatever the hell you're saying.
Nip it in the bud.
That's the best Barney Fife I've ever heard. No question. Nothing else is even close. I'm Howie Carr.
The paper boy with a big microphone. Howie Carr.
What's the number one sign of a bad home security system? A home security system that's so complicated you never use it. This is exactly the type of security system SimpliSafe has spent a decade fighting against. They believe that simple is safer. SimpliSafe was designed to be easy to use while protecting your whole home 24/7. Order online with the click of a button. Open the box, place the sensors, plug it in, and your home is protected around the clock.
And Howie, I just want to say, as someone who just bought a new house, that a lot of people won't be coming to your house anytime soon because of the new rules set in place for quarantine. So SimpliSafe is awesome because it is easy. You can do it all yourself. You do not need to be an electrician, or you don't need to even be really good with technology.
SimpliSafe was named best overall home security of 2020 by U.S. News and World Report. And their 24/7 professional monitoring and emergency dispatch starts at just 50 cents a day. Head to SimpliSafeHowie.com and get free shipping and a 60-day money-back guarantee. That's SimpliSafeHowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you.
I'm the Vice President of the United States.
Love him or hate him, Joe Biden's here for the long haul. But we can't get enough of his gaffes. Here's the best of Uncle Joe's speaking before he thinks.
We choose truth over facts.
When the stock market crashed, Franklin Roosevelt got on television.
Make sure you have the record player on at night.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
Okay, well, you can frack with me later, okay?
The teachers are recon. I'm married to a teacher. My deceased wife is a teacher.
And Corn Pop was a bad dude.
I can tell you, and I've known 8 presidents, 3 of the minimum.
If you agree with me, go to Joe 30330 and help me.
Had over 40 kids shot at Kent State on a beautiful lawn.
I love this place. Look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it?
I said something that was not meant the way I said.
I mean, what is it that I said wrong?
I want to be clear. I'm not going nuts. Anyway, my time's up. I'm sorry.
We all shop online, and now you can do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer! Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
Hi, this is Cindy from Osterville, Massachusetts.
This is Brett Rock from Dunstable, Massachusetts.
This is Amy in Lisbon Falls, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
And so you asked other parts of a question. I can't remember what other ones were. One was, what am I going to do about immigration? What was the other part? Is that it?
Never mind. Willie Nelson will answer the question after he finishes his bone. Skip the hassle at the grocery store and sign up to get delicious, high-quality meat delivered fresh to your door at butcherbox.com/Howie. That's butcherbox.com/Howie. It's the best. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Do bars pose any more of a threat of COVID-19 exposure than a trip to the supermarket?
No, and they don't pose any more of a threat than riots and looting.
65% say no.
All right. Sad news from Western Mass. The Big E has officially been canceled in West Springfield for September. It's looked like it was going that way, but it's I'm very disappointed. I always like going to the Big E with Grace, and she gets to see the big horse, and we get to eat eclairs and whatever kind of strange hamburgers and donuts that they have. It's a lot of fun. And I've been going there a long, long time, longer than I care to remember. But I won't be going there this year, and no, neither will anybody else. All right, 844-500-4242. Let's just go over some of these horrible statistics about what happened this weekend around the country. 18 dead, 47 wounded in Chicago weekend shootings. I was thinking about trying to read this whole list, but there's too many. Even if we were a local Chicago station, I think there would be too many, actually. It's sad. And nobody's talking about this. You know, they're talking about Donald Trump and the Taliban bounty. And it's a non-story. It never happened. But they don't want to talk about 18 dead, 47 wounded in Chicago. Four children were among the 65 people shot across Chicago this weekend, 18 of them fatally. Three of the children were killed. The weekend gun violence brought Chicago past 300 homicides so far this year. Last year, the city didn't break 300 homicides until early August, according to Chicago Sun-Times data. A 10-year-old girl was fatally shot Saturday night when a stray bullet hit her inside a Logan Square home on the northwest side. The shots may have come from a group of males who had been firing at each other in the block. A little boy was killed Saturday and his mother wounded in a shooting in Inglewood, which I think is on the south side. They were driving home from a laundromat just after 2 p.m. A laundromat at 2 p.m. in the middle of the day when a gunman pulled up alongside them in another vehicle and opened fire. Earlier that morning, a teenage boy was shot to death in Humboldt Park on the west side. A male suspect approached him and shot him in the face and leg. Nearly 2 hours before that, a man was found shot to death in Humboldt Park. It's the same place, west side. The 22-year-old was discovered inside a home with gunshot wounds. On Sunday night, a man was shot and killed in Garfield Park on the west side, 23. Earlier Sunday night, another man was killed in West Pullman on the far south side. Someone in a black vehicle shot him in the head and the back and the shoulder. Three people were killed in separate shootings within 90 minutes on Sunday morning, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Meanwhile, in Atlanta, on Friday, they were, it happened Monday. There was a meeting of the city council's public safety committee, and they were talking with the new police chief, the interim police chief, and they were having a virtual meeting. And in the middle of the meeting, Councilman Antonio Brown, who represents the district just west of downtown, was getting ready to speak when he told the chief, "I was just notified there's a young man who was just shot and killed at 377 Westchester Street, and no police have been there." But there's more. This is a columnist for the Atlanta Journal-Constitution. Seems like he's a level-headed columnist. It's hard to believe. On June 13th, as angry protesters milled around the South Atlanta Wendy's the day after Rayshard Brooks was shot in the parking lot, there was a wild shootout in the Edgewood neighborhood in East Atlanta. Five people were wounded and two were killed. Earlier this month, the owners of a bar in the popular Edgewood Avenue nightlife district posted a photo online of the business's windows smashed by a bullet. They said they felt unsafe and were closing, quote, until the city gets its bleep together. What caused this? 8 people were shot nearby in 6 days. Headline this weekend, 6 injured in 3 overnight drive-by shootings in Atlanta. One of the victims was 10 years old. I'm Howie Carr. Hey campers, this is Howie Carr. Camping season is here and Cold Springs RV is ready for you. If a new or pre-owned camper has been on your wish list, now is the time to check it off. Go see all the great specials at Cold Springs RV and score a deal on a pop-up, travel trailer, fifth wheel, or motorhome. Cold Springs is your destination for all things camping. If it is service you need, the brand new state-of-the-art service facility is ready for you, servicing all makes and brands. If your RV needs body work, whether it's a collision repair, roof replacement, or a new paint job, they have you covered. From minor repairs to major insurance jobs, Cold Springs RV can do it all. As a full-service RV dealer, you know they can fix just about anything. If it is time for your first RV or 10th RV, Cold Springs is ready for you. Cold Springs RV, your destination for all things camping. Route 114, Ware, New Hampshire. ColdSpringsRV.com.
President Trump's life has changed a lot in the last couple of years, but one thing that remains consistent, his love for a good nickname.
What happened to Minnie Mike? Where is he? Minnie Mike, I've had him up to here. Sleepy Joe has no idea what he's even talking. He doesn't even know what he's talking about. Sleepy Joe, get off the stage, please.
I don't think the guy's got a chance. Sleepy Joe, I don't think he's got it.
I don't know. I think Sleepy Joe may be able to limp across the finish line.
Crying Chuck. I don't want to say Crazy Nancy because if I say that, you're going to say it's a copy of Crazy Bernie, and that's no good.
Who did you? Alfred E. Newman.
You know, I thought Pocahontas was gone, left in embers. I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year.
Did you ever hear Pocahontas? It's Pocahontas, Elizabeth Warren.
Little pencil neck Adam Schiff. Got the smallest, thinnest neck I've ever seen.
But Nancy Pelosi, I call her Nervous Nancy.
Crooked Hillary.
Crooked Hillary Clinton.
Bill Clinton said to Crooked Hillary, Crooked Hillary, do you think he calls her Crooked Hillary, Mike?
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring 3 things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer. And I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books. Too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
Joe Biden doesn't have time for malarkey, and he also doesn't have a lot of time for geography. Take a listen.
The people of Nevada are watching, and I'm going to be out there seeing them very soon. Tonight, though, we just heard from the first 2 of 50 states. It's important that Iowa and Nevada have spoken, but look, we need to hear from Nevada and South Carolina and Super Tuesday states and beyond.
And Biden doesn't know the difference between Iran and Iraq. He's gotten it wrong 4 times.
We tried it in Iraq. It's not working, so now we're going to try, in Iran? Excuse me. We tried in Ukraine.
He always always gets the name wrong.
I love this place. I love, look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it? And what a neat town. What a, I mean, this is sort of a scenic, beautiful town. I like Keene a lot.
How many times has he missed it? He's an Iowa wizard. Great to be in the great state of Ohio. And they say, Joe, you're in Iowa.
How many unsafe bridges you still have here in the state of Ohio? I mean, Iowa. And I was just in Ohio because they have more.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. And every Monday, unless we do it Tuesday or Wednesday, this is the time for Hate Mail Monday.
Let the hate flow through you.
We've been on a streak the last couple weeks. We've actually been doing it on Monday.
That's right. We're very fortunate.
You know what I credit this to?
What?
You've been having very social weekends out and about, and you've been posting pictures on your Twitter, and it really, really generates a lot of material for this particular segment.
That's right. We had a great time over the weekend down on Cape Cod. We visited Cape Gunworks. We got some shooting in with former Lieutenant Jimmy Kelly of the Boston PD. And Taylor was there. Taylor, you have a good time?
That was a lot of fun. Yeah.
We did. We
had a lot of headshots.
And there were a lot of people there. It was packed.
Howie tried a crossbow.
I did.
The mailroom manager tried a crossbow.
Wowzers.
Yeah. I found a nice little gun. It's going to be a nice Christmas. It's so small, it's going to be a stocking stuffer for Christmas. It's really cool. Fits right in my pocket.
Ooh, that sounds like a kind of gun I would like.
It's like an automatic Derringer, as Lieutenant Kelly described it. And
we both like the .22 long rifle.
Oh, that was nice. That looks like that guy in St. Louis had something like that.
Yeah, well, he had a Colt AR-15.
Well, it's kind of the same thing. It looks the same.
It's a gun that Maura Healey would ban.
Right, right. It's big, scary. It's a big, scary rifle. It's a black, scary rifle. That's what he called it. A BSR. And then we went down to Moby Dick's in Wellfleet and had some really good meals with a couple of really good meals with Todd. And
did you have some oysters?
Yeah, I had a lot of oysters.
I've heard great
oysters.
Things about
I had
oysters.
Oysters on the half shell, Wellfleet oysters, of course. They're the best. And we stayed over at the Wakwasset in Harwich.
Beautiful.
That's
beautiful
where you're having
spot.
Your engagement party.
Yes, I am. That's a beautiful spot.
And that's a really nice spot too. They're doing better. And you know, on the weekends they're not having as many they're not having any conferences, obviously. But they still got room on the weekdays if you want to go down there.
Oh, very nice. The rooms are beautiful. If you haven't seen
they
it,
are.
You should check it out.
The Wakwasset in Harwich. So we had a great time, and we thank everybody, all of our hosts, and we had a fantastic time.
Well, actually, I'm going to start with one of your pictures.
But of course, some people didn't like that I was enjoying myself.
There's always a turd in this punch bowl of Hate Mail Monday.
A snake at the garden party, as
exactly. So I'm going to start with the photo of you, Howie. You were holding your gun out and aiming it towards the, what do they call that? The poster?
The target.
The target. Can you guys tell that I'm not a great shooter? And someone wrote, old crazy racist with a gun, joining America's terrorist ranks or what?
Boy, I guess there were a lot of crazy racists with guns at Cape Gunworks.
Wow. And I, by the way, I have a license to carry. Do you think, how many of those shootings in Chicago, Atlanta, New York, Seattle, how many of those people have licenses, do you think?
That is a Republican talking point, Howie.
I'm trying to weaponize the use of illegal firearms. I'm pouncing and seizing upon the statistics.
The next picture on Twitter that garnered a lot of messages, I just want to clarify. I did Howie a huge favor. So the mailroom manager sent me a photo of Howie with his dog, Gunnar, in a baby carriage. Obviously, that was going to generate some conversations. What I did out of respect for Howard, because sometimes I don't know how much he can handle hate-wise, the original photo had a lot of his leg in short pants.
I've seen the original. I can attest to this. And she did us all a favor.
I ran it by Taylor. I said, do you think I should crop his leg out? I don't know if people can handle this, you know, at 9 in the morning or whatever time I was tweeting it out. However, Even with the cropped picture, you got some hate. Someone said, wow, you are officially out of your mind. It's a dog.
It's a dog that I've owned I've shared my life with for 18 and a half years.
A beautiful dog. A talented dog.
Yes.
Another person didn't focus on the dog and instead said, is that Mike Barnacle in his new career?
I didn't come here to be made sport of, you know.
And another person...
I'm a nonfiction columnist.
I didn't print this out because it technically wasn't hate towards you, but I feel like you'll take it just as personally, so it'll have the same effect. Another person said that Gunnar needs to start using that men hair shampoo.
Like
that
Grecian Formula 44 or something like that?
Yeah, because she has a lot of gray hairs.
So does her master. You know, when they're... When
Gunnar's a blonde?
That's true.
I did not know that.
When I bought Gunnar, I had dark hair and Gunnar had dark hair.
It's crazy. You do not see a lot of blonde black pugs out there, but I guess it happens. Okay, so another person was commenting on your article in the Boston Herald, and it was about Charlie Baker and about the nursing homes. And he wrote a pretty benign comment. He said,
did this just happen?
This was a couple days ago. He said, I'm looking forward to moving to a nice red state. Okay?
Yeah.
But the Trump deranged, even the simplest comment can really anger them. This woman wrote, feel free, they're full of uneducated, fat slob, lazy government handouts like yourself.
Really?
In the red states.
Is that right?
I'm noticing that a lot of your comments from people who don't like you, they will not just, I've said this before, they don't just criticize you. They criticize anyone who lives in a red state. There's a real elitism to this hate that we get every week. So,
well, I can see why, because Massachusetts is so on the up and up right now. Massachusetts is in wonderful condition, wouldn't you say?
Well, Howie, this is one that I think you're really going to like. So this guy writes, there was an article about Tom Brady and how he was exercising or practicing.
Right.
Practicing.
Yeah. He and Russell Wilson from the Seahawks, they were both practicing without, he's the quarterback of the Seahawks. They were both practicing without masks. Even the NFL Players Association came after him. I couldn't believe it.
So someone tweeted out that article, and then two guys on Twitter, because what I do is I look up Howie's name and I see where he appears. And where he's appearing a lot right now is he is appearing as an insult you can use towards people. Like, you know how sometimes you'll say, oh, go put on your tinfoil hat. Now the new insult is, oh, go read your Howie Carr columns, or go listen to Howie Carr. It's becoming a trend. So this person tweeted out the article about Tom Brady, and another guy who was very interested in having a civil conversation wrote, just so we're clear, Mass has a population of 7 million people. Mass has 109 cases, 109,000 cases and 8,000 deaths. Florida has a population of 22 million. Florida has 132,000 cases and 3,300 deaths, less than half the deaths. With a population that's three times as large and much older, Mass could learn from Florida.
Yes, I would agree with that.
So this guy writes back, yeah, this tweet will not age well. They are not even at the top of the curve. To which this Republican writes back, I'm giving you actual data, and the 14-day trend graphs are available on the Georgia State website, and actual facts like Massachusetts let seniors die while Florida and Georgia had National Guard protect them.
Right.
You keep giving me, just wait 2 more weeks, and that's what we've heard for 2 months.
More than 2 months.
To which the final Moonbat response is this. You can spot Howie Carr readers from a mile away.
And you know what my sin is, Grace? You know this because you're involved in it every day. I print the actual Massachusetts own state statistics.
How dare you? How dare you?
That drives them nuts.
So I'm
drives
not,
them nuts. 8,000 deaths, 130 under the age of 50.
I am not done yet, but I wanted to let everyone know that Hate Mail Monday is brought to you by Piant Josie Baking Company, celebrating over 100 years of baking excellence since 1916. We talk a lot here about Butcher Box, their delicious meat, their delicious sausages, and I want to tell everyone I had a Butcher Box sausage this weekend, and if you have the Piant Josie bread roll, Howie, It's just delicious. There's no fresher bread. So really, it's a great combo.
Yes, and you it's not like you can go down to Fenway Park to Lansdowne Street and have a sausage sandwich.
No. Those days are
with onions
long
and peppers on it. Those that's
you can't go to David Ortiz Drive.
That's gone, like the Big E.
Right.
At least temporarily.
Howie, this guy, you've been noticing, he has the icon, because I know you read your hate on the Boston Herald. It says, Flush, Please, and his name is Mueller, the Avenging Angel.
Yeah, what did Mueller avenge? Recurring question.
He's your new biggest hater. He wrote this in your column, again, about Charlie Baker. There's been so many Charlie Baker ones, so I'm just, you know. You can figure out which
Charlie Parker. Let's get it straight.
I'm sorry. He says the latest installment from Owie Howie, the one-note wonder, who is in the buffet line in Mar-a-Lago, waiting for Doofus to hand him
Mar-a-Lago.
The shrimp. Waiting for Doofus to hand him the shrimp scampi tongs.
This guy's got a whole fantasy going here.
He's got to suck up to Dear Leader. How about joining a club in this state and helping the locals, Howie? You're pathetic. Get a life. Sad. He likes
how
about Donald
if I
Trump
join,
sad.
How about if I join Sam's Club?
Hey, that works for me. We've got a message from Granny here. We'll play that.
Hi, I know you're not listening, but that's okay. Howie, you called someone ignorant just a few seconds ago. I tuned in really, really late. So you admit Trump is ignorant. Thank God. Finally.
I don't believe I said that about Mr. Trump.
Well, she's Granny. Like the New York Times, you know, she can take you out of context, she can take
right.
a quote.
It's
she
an
can
anonymous
it.
An anonymous source.
Right.
And so then when you say, could we see the actual memo or the email or the raw intelligence? Oh, it doesn't exist. Oh, but it's on the front page?
So another person was getting into a political argument with a blue check mark. And I don't want to even name them because I'm not really sure who they are. But someone replied to this blue check. And you know what his new response is? This is a new argument from the liberals. They're getting into it again. Someone presents facts to the argument and the liberal just simply writes back, if Howie Carr follows you, you can't possibly be a good person or on the right side more than once or twice a decade.
Oh. Okay, I thought we celebrated diversity, and why can't we all just get along?
I totally agree, Howie. Now, I would also like to read this one. This is when we got on the text line, which I really liked, because some people get really mad because they hate Trump, and then some people really like us, but they get really mad because we use improper grammar, and those are the people that I want to really, you know, dig in and see what's going on there, because there's something off. If someone else's grammar gets you this mad, there's something wrong there. This guy writes, I guess you said people like ourselves at some point in the past.
Yeah.
Okay. And I saw this text come in and I decided to copy and paste it. He said, people like us, not ourselves. Will you please stop putting a self/selves on pronouns that have no use for them? You're starting to sound like a real bleep. I love you, but please speak correct English. You change the meaning of a word when you add a self. You and yourself are not interchangeable. They have different uses and meanings.
There was a good movie in the 70s, Thieves Like Us. I always thought it should have been named Thieves Like Ourselves.
Spies Like Us. Spies Like Ourselves.
Right.
By the way, this is an old hate mail that I received and I forgot to read, but I really enjoyed it because someone took their time to email it to me. They labeled it correctly. They wanted it to be read on hate mail. 2 weeks ago, I wore a red polka dot dress. This hate mail is simple, but to the point. Hey, Grace, that red polka dot dress you were wearing last week, your mom wants it back. Wholesome.
Oh.
That's a wholesome
shot
email.
At you and Mrs. Curly.
Yes.
Oh,
by
my.
The way, my mom would probably not have bought that dress.
Mama Curly will
She has
fight
better
you.
Style than me.
Well, it sounds like they another insult would have been, who shot the tablecloth at the Italian restaurant?
We don't hate on each other here, Howie.
I just thought
we
of another insult
if I was
going to use it.
We have one more hate mail, Howie. You've been called a lot of things.
I wore a coat once and somebody said, who shot the couch? And so I ran into a mafia guy named the Saint, and he was wearing a coat like that. And I said, "Hey, Saint, who shot the couch?"
Very good.
And you know what he said? "You shouldn't say stuff like that."
"Yeah, maybe I'll shoot you, huh?"
Taylor, let's play the last hate mail.
"I'm calling to let you people know, and especially Howie Carr, y'all are all fascists. Y'all couldn't back off of Trump if a gun was put to your head."
Y'all.
Fascist.
Fascist. It takes one to know one. Maybe. Once again, projection. We've seen a lot of it since November 8th, 2016, and it doesn't stop.
That was Hate Mail Monday, brought to you by Piantedosi Baking Company. Make sure you check them out. And guys, keep sending your hate. I love it.
And we'll take some calls when we come back. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
A nightmare to liberals everywhere. He's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Route 1 Grill House in Saugus, located just before the Cactus. From their steak tips and ribs, the Route 1 Grill House has it all. Open now 7 days a week for both outdoor and indoor dining. Hey campers, this is Howie Carr. Camping season is here, and Cold Springs RV is ready for you. If a new or pre-owned camper has been on your wish list, now is the time to check it off. Go see all the great specials at Cold Springs RV and score a deal on a pop-up, travel trailer, fifth wheel, or motorhome. Cold Springs is your destination for all things camping. If it is service you need, the brand new state-of-the-art service facility is ready for you, servicing all makes and brands. If your RV needs body work, whether it's a collision repair, roof replacement, or a new paint job, they have you covered. From minor repairs to major insurance jobs, Cold Springs RV can do it all. As a full-service RV dealer, you know they can fix just about anything. If it is time for your first RV or 10th RV, Cold Springs is ready for you. Cold Springs RV, your destination for all things camping. Route 114, Ware, New Hampshire. ColdSpringsRV.com. The Democrat Party is so full of loonies, social justice warriors, progressives, whatever you want to call them, that sometimes certain moonbats get overlooked. So let's take this moment to shine the woke spotlight on Crazy Maisie Hirono.
I am not going to be a fool to Mitch McConnell's shenanigans. Why should any of us?
And it's not just a dog whistle, it's a bullhorn.
Bullhorns. It's racism. It's basically, for many people, it's anti-Semitic. It's white supremacy.
Why not take a stand and vote yes for it? Seems like you're trying to have it both ways. Not be hung by it politically, but also not say that you don't support it.
I disagree with you, Katie, that why should we engage in the kind of sham shenanigans that Mitch McConnell is really good at?
I'm confused.
This was just a sham.
Guess who's perpetuating all of these kinds of actions? It's the men in this country. And I just want to say to the men of this country, just shut up and step up.
I think the noose is closing. And, you know, Giuliani is like a loose cannon. And so is the president, frankly.
With all the uncertainty in the world, feeling safe at home has never been more important. It's why I want to talk to you about Simply Safe Home Security. They're longtime friends of the Howie Carr Show. And for good reason. Simply Safe has made it easy to finally get comprehensive protection for your home. There's no technician or salesperson that needs to come and disrupt your house. You don't need to pay any outrageous monthly fees or sign a 2-year contract. You just order online, set it up yourself in under an hour, and your home is protected 24/7 with emergency dispatch for break-ins, fire, and more. All for just 50 cents a day. And we're not the only fans of Simply Safe. U.S. News and World Report named Simply Safe best overall home security of 2020. Go to simplysafehowie.com to try it out for yourself. That's simplysafehowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you. That's simplysafehowie.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's what I'm saying. I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives.
This is Kevin from Brockton.
This is Karen from Boiling Springs, South Carolina.
This is Officer Mark calling from beautiful Stratford County, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Several people have texted or called up the listener line asking for a book on the founding of the CIA and all the infighting between J. Edgar Hoover and the predecessor of the CIA, the OSS, and how the mafia, the organized crime, was involved. And I don't know a specific book about it, but I've read a lot about it. And I just gave the number, the name to a caller, Official and Confidential. It's a biography of J. Edgar Hoover by a guy named Summers, Anthony Summers. I think he's a Brit or was a Brit. And that's where I got a lot of my information. But I've read several books on it, but that'll get you started on something. And it's just a treasure trove of dirt and gossip in the first three quarters, basically, of the 20th century. All right. Alice, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Alice.
Hey, Howie.
Hi.
I just want to say that I think that you are great as far as your politics go. I agree with you.
Thanks.
Almost 100%. And I like your interview with Judge Denver. And however, I have one bone to pick with you.
Sure.
I think that you're scoffing a little too much at the people who wear masks and your comment about being down in Chatham, and you seem to make fun of them. You know, I live in Falmouth, and most of the people wear masks, even the tourists, when you see them on the sidewalk, if they don't wear
masks. See, I just don't think the masks are necessary. I got to play a cut from this, I guess he's a talk show host. He's in Ventura County, California. And the county decided to require people to wear masks. This was after the health director for the county had said that in March that masks were totally worthless, and now they're going to be required. And this guy just took him right down. And I think masks, if you want to wear a mask, I got nothing against it. It's a free country, but I don't think I should have to wear a mask. I'm older, but I'm not really in the most vulnerable group in the sense that I don't have any comorbidities and I'm not overweight. But I don't know why I have to wear a mask. I don't get it. And I don't think I should have to wear a mask. And if you want to wear a mask, that's fine. And if you're afraid to go to a restaurant, don't go to a restaurant. But don't stop me from going. I'm Howie Carr.
We here at Matthews Brothers are just as anxious as the next fella to get back out into society. Not that we didn't enjoy all that quality family time over the past few weeks. All 5,301,672 seconds of it. And it was fun putting on a mask before going into the bank and the liquor store. And we really enjoyed calling window companies and begging for a salesman to come on out. And while the past few weeks may have given us a pretty good idea of what eternity will feel like, it also made us realize how precious and fragile our freedoms can be. It made us realize that although we were all in the same storm, we were not all in the same boat. And we realize that every job is essential, no matter what the government may think. Our thanks to everyone whose personal sacrifices helped us weather this storm, and especially to the men and women of Matthews Brothers who stood shoulder to socially distant shoulder as they continued their mission of providing consistently superior customer service. You can see the results of their relentless passion for making wicked awesome windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals, or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black, and it's because of all the recycling that was going on, so I try to keep my taxes down that way.
He's New England's talk radio king. He's Howie Carr.
The only French term I like is sans culotte, without trousers. I used to describe Ted Kennedy as sans culotte. Because after the O'Barr incident, when he was wandering around down on the beach with his 20th scotch tumbler of the day in his hand, stumbling around with an off. He was just there, as the Michelle Cassone, Patches Date, said. He was just there, without trousers. Or as we say in Paris, sans culotte.
We've seen nothing that we can work, that I can work with President Bush on, and I'm disappointed because I thought that there might be some interest because of what he said in the campaign.
President Bush, this is your brain. This is your brain on Botox, okay? That's the lesson of that one.
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Can you remember any time in your life when you were starstruck?
One time I saw Peter Vesey, the NBA columnist for the New York Post. He was in the Herald sports department. I really liked his column, so I went up and introduced myself to him. Then one time there was Cousin Brucey from WABC, and I used to listen to him driving back and forth between Chapel Hill and Deerfield when I was in college. Everybody on the East Coast listened to him. I couldn't believe that I was in the presence of Cousin Brucey.
Do you ever play bridge anymore?
No, I haven't played bridge in a very long time. Nobody I know plays bridge. I think my bridge days are behind me.
Do you think you'd still be good at it?
I'm not a great bidder, but I know how to count cards. That, to me, is the essence of playing a hand of bridge, is to be able to count cards.
What is a rhino?
Rhino is a Republican in name only. Think Paul Ryan. Oh, think Mitt Romney. Think Jeff Flake. The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13-year-old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okey-doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia, not Al-Qaeda. You said Russia. In the 1980s are now calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
Mike Bloomberg is spending millions of dollars on all of his campaign ads, but we put together some of our favorite Bloomberg clips, and guess what, Mike? This one's totally free.
I think we disproportionately stop whites too much and minorities too little.
To be a farmer, it's a process. You dig a hole, you put a seed in, you put dirt on top, add water, up comes the corn. Then we had 300, you could learn that.
Donald Trump is the world's biggest schoolyard bully.
Big gay ice cream is the best.
The Communist Party wants to stay in power in China, and they listen to the public. When the public says, I can't breathe the air, Xi Jinping is not a dictator. He has to satisfy his constituents, or he's not going to survive.
He's not a dictator?
No, he has a constituency to answer to.
I'm ready to get to work, so let's get it on.
I would be 79 years old when I took office. To start a four-year job, maybe an eight-year job at age 79 may not be the smartest thing to do.
Why did you say what you said in that 2015 speech?
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who do you consider the biggest rhino in the Republican Party?
Probably is Paul Ryan. I wish a Republican were still the speaker, but Paul Ryan was scarcely a Republican. And there was a reason he was Mitt Romney's running mate, because we had a rhino ticket in 2012.
Where did the expression, how many more, Mr. Speaker, how many more, come from?
That comes from the State House. There used to be a state rep who sometimes would talk about atrocities that were happening in crime. And he would get up there and he would say, how many more, Mr. Speaker?
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Russian intelligence officials offered cash incentives to Taliban militants in Afghanistan to kill US or UK troops.
President Trump was told about this in March, and he has done nothing.
He is so addled and mentally deficient, right, that they didn't think it was worth their time telling him.
This is as bad as it gets. And yet the president will not confront the Russians on this score.
His entire presence has been a gift to Putin, but this is beyond the pale.
I think the more likely answer to this is some early intelligence, hasn't been verified, hasn't been vetted, and they're checking it out now. What if he acts on it and it turns out not to be true?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
A shooting overnight in Seattle's CHOP.
This is the second double shooting near the Capitol Hill-occupied protest zone known as CHOP in just about 8 days.
Two people were hit by gunfire around 3 this morning. One of the victims died.
Kids, you noticing all this flight? Roll them up.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
You know what this is? This is the mountain. This is the mountain that New Yorkers climb. You know, I keep showing the curve. This is the curve. It's actually proportionate We don't want to climb this mountain again.
That is one big pile of shit.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The Democratic Party of Orange County wants to change the name of John Wayne Airport. A newly drafted resolution cites racist and bigoted statements made by the actor in a 1971 interview. It calls on the Board of Supervisors to restore the airport's original name, which was Orange County Airport.
Fill your hand, you son of a bitch!
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. 603 says, boy, are you stupid. Masks are for the benefits of others. Do you know if you have COVID? Cite your only source, one that agrees with you. Won't read this one because you don't have a comeback. I'll cite my source, Dr. Anthony Fauci. He said in March there was no need to wear masks. Okay? Is that good enough for you? All right. 844-500.
There's no reason to be walking around with a mask. When you're in the middle of an outbreak, wearing a mask might make people feel a little bit better, and it might even block a droplet, but it's not providing the perfect protection that people think that it is.
That's my comeback. 844-500-4242. Some local news here. The homes of several Boston city councilors were targeted over the weekend by vandals apparently upset over the city's budget, which included cuts to the police department's overtime budget that some say didn't go far enough, officials said. So they don't know if it's pro. They didn't say which councilors had their homes vandalized. But I found this comment odd by the mayor. Vandalism. Some people are fans of it. I've never been a fan of it. Some people are fans of vandalism, but he's never been a fan of it. What about the beheading of the Christopher Columbus statue in the North End, Mayor? I thought you said you had nothing against it being taken down, did you? That's the way I recall it. I mean, you'd say, well, I didn't say vandalize it, but, you know, I mean, chopping its head off basically required it to be taken down. So you really weren't. All right. Anyway, there's more news to the Encore Casino. Before we became Massachusetts, they had 4,200 employees in the Everett Casino, the Encore Casino. They furloughed 3,000 of their workers today. They've been kind of hanging on, hoping that something was going to happen, but they can't wait for phase three forever. So the 4,200 employees in March are now down to 700. And meanwhile, Boston University, not being a public college that can just keep sucking money from the taxpayers like the University of Massachusetts, is trying to deal with a $96 million shortfall, even after $168 million in cuts in the new fiscal year budget. So they've laid off 250 people today. So, and meanwhile, there are 8,000 people dead in the state, and 5,000 of them are in nursing homes that are heavily regulated by Governor Charlie Parker's incompetent, corrupt administration. And de Blasio is cutting $1 billion from the city police budget in New York City amidst a spike in the crime rates. I'm using spike or surge. Is it a spike or a surge? They always keep talking about people testing positive for COVID. It's always a spike or a surge. So I'm going to say that. Meanwhile, murders are spiking and surging in Seattle, the CHOP zone. One man was killed and a teenager was wounded early Monday in Seattle's occupied protest zone. Excuse me, the second deadly shooting in the area that local officials have vowed to change. They vowed to change. This is the AP. Vowed to change. They vowed to shut it down, haven't they? And meanwhile, the mayor of Seattle just twiddles her thumbs and wrings her hands and dithers. She dithers and calls it two dead now, at least two dead. There's been one rape, couple of shootings, beatings, multiple extortions in the block party atmosphere, as she calls it, the mayor, in the summer of love. The summer of love. It's quite loving. 844-500-4242-781. Never going back to NYC in this lifetime. I think a lot of people who've lived in New York City are desperate to get out. Desperate. One thing I heard on the Cape was that, you know, any summer rental is being snapped up, you know, because these are people who can't, that normally would go to Europe, you know, Europe shut down. They can't even go to Maine. Maine is shut down. So they're heading for the Cape, even though, you know, the Cape is, you know, they only have 50% capacity still in the restaurants. They still, you can't have wedding receptions of over 10 people in most places. It's still not what it used to be, but it's better than a lot of places. And I also heard Cape real estate is going in hours once it's posted because people just can't get out of the city fast enough. I am so glad that I never bought anything. Not that I was ever thinking of buying anything in the Seaport District of Boston. Can you imagine what white elephants? Can you say white elephant anymore? What albatrosses those are going to be.
How dare you?
What alcatrazes those are going to be around people's necks trying to get rid of them. Those multi-million dollar condos that went up in parking lots over the last few years. 844-500-4242. Pete, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Pete.
Hi, Howie. I thought it was funny when Biden used the term beyond the pale. That has its origins in the 16th century.
Right.
England's attitude about the Irish beyond the fence, outside of their control. They thought
right.
They were reprobates. So Biden is, in effect, not being very socially sensitive in their sanctimonious way. I find it ironic that he seems not to know where the term came from.
I have no doubt that he doesn't know where the term came from. Do you, Pete? I thought of the same thing myself. But beyond the pale, that's where the all the quote-unquote bad Irish were pushed when the English, the new model army of Oliver Cromwell, solidified the English control. And if you wanted to speak Gaelic and practice Roman Catholicism, you know, without too many restrictions, you had to go beyond the pale into the west of Ireland, into Connaught, I think it was. And but Joe Biden, the proud Irishman, he knows none of that stuff. There's so very much that he doesn't know, including sometimes the office he's running for, or the president of the United States. Maria, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Maria.
Hi, Howie.
Hi.
Just listening to your intro while I was listening today.
Yes.
I know that we weren't always, you know, kind to Barack Obama, but the left and the media are absolutely disgusting the way that they talk about Donald Trump. Absolutely disgusting. He gets blamed for everything, no matter what it is. And how, all right, even if he wins, I do believe that he's going to win. It's not like anyone has a choice. It's either what we have today or hopefully something better tomorrow.
Yeah.
But what happens in 4 years? I just keep envisioning the United States splitting in half because there is no coming together anymore between Republicans and Democrats.
I tend to agree with you, Maria, but I think we got to get through this election first. You know, it's like the old 12-step program, one day at a time. You know, we got to get through this election first. It's like every election now is do or die, make or break. You know, I mean, the left accuses us of doing everything that they want to do to us. And that's basically shutting down the republic. They don't believe in freedom of speech. That's what the cancel culture is all about, is ending your First Amendment rights. They don't believe in any kind of political discourse or debate. It's their way or the highway. And you know, what's theirs is theirs, and what's yours is theirs. Everything is up for grabs, and it's kind of scary. What's at stake in this election? And you know, even before all the problems started, Trump was saying in his rallies, you know, you may not like me, but you don't really have any choice, do you? And you know what? He was right. He is right. Thanks for the call, Maria. John, you're next with Howie. Or we'll, okay, go ahead, John.
Hey, Howie, real quick. I was just going to let you know, there's a guy who's been on OAN. His name's Dennis Randicourt.
Yeah.
He's a professor of physics, and he's actually done a lot of work on these masks.
Yeah.
He's with the Ontario Civil Liberties Union, and he's been handling lawsuits. And basically, he said, you'll love this because of the Trump controversy. He said there's been no double-blind studies that show that masks work.
Yeah. You know, John, isn't it? It's just kind of like a form of submission, isn't it? The government demands that you do something, and the requirements of masks seems to increase as the number of deaths goes down. Have you noticed that, John? I don't care about people testing positive. I care about who's dying. That's the most significant statistic, isn't it? And we never hear that anymore, do we?
Now, the whole thing is this fellow that explained it, and again, he was a professor of physics at one time.
Yeah.
He said, look, the way people wear these masks, if they sneeze or cough, it's too late. The droplets are going all over the place anyway. So he goes, it really doesn't work. And he's got, like I say, he's handling lawsuits for Ontario, but I'll send his name up. He'd be a good guest for the show because he really did a good job explaining it.
Yes. Text that name to me, 63566. Text it to me. Thank you, John. I'm Howie Carr.
He's suave, he's debonair, he's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by the Nauset Beach Inn. With an ocean view from every room and at a price you can afford, the Nauset Beach Inn is also pet-friendly. To book today, go to NausetBeachInn.com. Do you have no water, poor water quality, or low pressure? This is Howie Carr. Call the local water service experts, Skillings and Sons. They're ready with 24-hour service with no extra charge for after-hours calls. And a fleet of trucks stocked with parts to make sure you're not without water. With over 50 years of experience, they take pride in having a family of employees that are the best in the business. For all things water, Skillings and Sons is there for you. SkillingsandSons.com.
Nothing says summer like fresh lobster and a beer, and Quahog Republic has them both. Featuring their lobster roll with 10 ounces of lobster meat, there's no mystery as to why they were voted best lobster roll in Massachusetts by Yankee Magazine. You can wash it down with Quahog's own golden ale. If you go for more of a mixed drink, then you cannot pass up their Bloody Mary with sun-dried tomatoes, peppers, and garlic, and they top it off with a nice piece of bacon. Visit them today at any of their 3 locations in New Bedford, Onset, or Falmouth. Quahog Republic. Live, give, and relax.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy'd out.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much. But no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gunnar is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
I've seen a lot of anchor cupcakes in my day. Here are some of the latest network nitwits.
Cheney says if I'm elected president, I will push for a constitutional amendment to impose term limits on all members of Congress. Correct me, there already are term limits, so what does he mean?
And what are we hearing in the background? Is that shelling?
No, Katie, you're actually hearing that from here in Jerusalem, and it's actually fireworks going off right behind me.
We're in our tribes, we're in our corners most of our lives. I think we just heard some gunshots. Should we listen to that for a second? Control room? Not gunshots? Okay. Ivanka is not the second lady. She is actually, I don't think she deserves this position. She's actually a senior advisor to the president. So the idea that he would demean her specifically in that way, he shouldn't talk about the first lady that way. We aren't all here to make salads for men. It's disgusting.
I mean, I'm presuming he was talking about Karen Pence when he said second lady.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Not Montana. I'm talking about never mind.
Yeah, no, Chester,
I was getting Montana and North Dakota confused because, I don't know, I just was.
This is Deb in Danielson, Connecticut.
This is Greg in Boston, Mass.
This is Elizabeth in Wakefield, Massachusetts, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Skip the hassle at the grocery store and sign up to get delicious, high-quality meat delivered fresh to your door at butcherbox.com/Howie. That's butcherbox.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Do bars pose any more of a threat of COVID-19 exposure than a trip to the supermarket?
No, I do not think so.
65% say no.
I'm going to sign an amicus curiae brief for the Texas bar owners, not just because my daughter works for one of the owners of one of the biggest bars in Texas. 844-500-4242. It was 4 years ago today that I was on Trump Force One with future President Donald Trump. We flew out of Boston to Bangor, Maine, and that's where I gave my famous, now famous, or then famous, Indian war whoop. I said, you remember Elizabeth Warren? You know Elizabeth Warren, the senator from my state, Massachusetts? And then I said, wah, 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 wah. Maybe Taylor can find the cut.
But he's certainly been amazing, and he's a very talented guy.
And then we flew back to LaGuardia, and I actually was taking grief on social media even before I finished introducing the future president, Donald Trump, in Bangor.
So where is Howie Carr, the legendary Howie, because he's here.
It was just crazy for about 24 hours because they were pretending I was some kind of racist, and She was a fake Indian, and I knew she was a fake Indian. And she, there it is. And she knew she was a fake Indian, but Rachel Maddow went crazy. They all went crazy. Donald Trump told me, he said, whatever you do, don't apologize, which I already knew anyway. He said, Jimmy the Greek, well, you remember Jimmy the Greek, Howie? He was doing great till he apologized. He was this guy, he was, I don't know what he said. He was an announcer for CBS, a sports color guy, and they got rid of him after he apologized. And Trump knew, you know, and I knew too from James Michael Curley, the old mayor.
You know Howie Carr?
Never complain, never explain, he said. And those are words to live by then and now. 844-500-4242. It was a fun night 4 years ago. It was a fun day 4 years ago going up on that plane. And as we were coming into LaGuardia, he said, Howie, go up into the cockpit there, because most people never get a chance to see the plane land in New York, especially with, you know, the metropolis. And it was pretty amazing. Joe, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Joe.
Hey, Howie, you were talking about the state of Maine. I was talking to producer. I was telling him for 25 years, my brothers and I have been going up to the Naples area, Long Lake, not sure if you're familiar with it. We had a week in May booked, canceled because of Governor Mills. And you know what? We ain't ever going back. We ended up booking a striped bass trip to Narragansett, Rhode Island.
Yeah.
We already booked for next year. I really think the state of Maine is really going to have a hard time recovering from what this Mills character has been doing. Boy, Paul LePage, I really hope he gets back there. And I'll tell you, I was on hold too, Howie, and I listened to your Nauset In Beach ad.
Yeah.
I actually sent you a text last week. I spent 2 days there last week, Moby Dick's. We had such a great time. It was free America.
Yeah. No, it was. We were at Moby. We didn't stop by the Nauset Beach Inn, but we stopped by Moby Dick's and, had a meal with Todd. And it was great. The food was fantastic. He's got all the tables outside, in the parking lot. They're extra tables. He's only at half capacity inside, obviously. But it's still great food. I mean, it's certainly freer than Maine. It's really sad. And we were asking the people that we visited on Cape Cod, are you getting any regular Maine people? And they said they're getting some. And when you lose a customer for whatever reason and he has to go somewhere else, there's a certain percentage of those people that are never going to come back. And I feel bad for Maine. And it's a break for Cape Cod. It's a, in your case, Joe, it's a break for Rhode Island. But some of these people just aren't coming back. You break the habit and you get into a new rhythm. It's a shame, and she doesn't seem to care. And I was telling that to Todd from Moby Dick's. I said, how would you like it if, you knew you were going to open up and then 4 days before Charlie Parker told you, well, no, I've decided you're not going to open up. As bad as Charlie Parker is, he didn't do that. Janet Mills did that to the people in Southern Maine. I'm Howie Carr.
Whether you're working from home or working on your fitness, you want what you're listening to be what you're listening to, not what your roommates or family are listening to. Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable noise isolating fit, perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was co-founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Get 15% off your order at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie for 15% off Raycon wireless earbuds. buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer, and I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books, too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great.
I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair.
For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie.
What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out?
Get the hair you've always wanted. hairman.com/Howie.
Bernie Sanders is officially in the race for 2020. Let's look back at some of the septuagenarian's greatest hits.
Should we give tax breaks to billionaires, which is what Trump wants, or demand that the wealthy and large corporations start paying their fair share of taxes?
Blah, 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 blah.
You know, it's funny. Sometimes American journalists talk about how bad a country is because people are lining up for food. That's a good thing. In other countries, people don't line up for food. The rich get the food and the poor starve to death.
We understand your wife has hired a lawyer to represent her in a possible probe into a land deal that fell apart. This was back when she was president of Burlington College.
No,
of course,
it was not
in your
when
state.
She was. Okay, let me say a word on that. You know.
Yeah. Well, I just want to ask you. Do you know
wife,
she's under FBI investigation?
Excuse me. My wife is about the most honest person I know.
At the end of the day, you don't necessarily need a choice of 23 underarm spray deodorants or 18 different pairs of sneakers.
People should not be dying in the United States of America when they are sick.
We will raise taxes.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States, next senator.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday. I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by, you know the thing.
It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Chris.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920 and not 2020.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
1-844-500-4242. So, Ventura County, California. You know, you remember the song by America. Maybe you don't. It wasn't that great of a song. But anyway, Ventura County didn't have a requirement for masks until last week. And then they decided, with cases falling, basically, the Governor Newsom has decided to keep the economy shut down because of the alleged spike in cases. I don't think there's been a spike in deaths per se, but there's been a spike in cases or people testing positive, which, you know, testing positive, you got a lot of bad stuff in your body, to use the medical terminology, at all times. And people recover from everything. But Ventura County decided that it was time to impose the mask requirement, like so many other places, like the town of Chatham, where I was this weekend for a brief, very brief amount of time. The town of Falmouth, I'm told, has a mask requirement. And Palm Beach County now has a mask requirement, where I just left. So they were having a meeting of the Board of Supervisors. And there was a guy showed up. His name is John Ziegler. I guess he has a talk show. I'm not familiar with him. But this is an epic rant. And he puts down these petty tyrants, these tin pot despots, these mandarins, that have no clue what they're talking about. He just calls them out on it. And he remembers what they were saying a couple of months ago. Let's hear it. It's 2 minutes, but it's great.
After waiting for 2 hours and now getting 2 minutes, I'll get right to the point. This board is pretending that for the last 3 months, your emperor, Dr. Levin, has not been against a mask declaration. Now, all of a sudden, we're pretending that masks are everything, even forcing speakers to use masks. I would like the board to take a position. Was Dr. Levin wrong for those 3 months? And if he was this wrong, why has he not been removed? Why has he not been fired for being so catastrophically wrong? Or do you not really believe he was wrong? You're just wearing these masks because it is a signal of your great virtue. Because for the last 3 months, we have not worn them. And Ventura County has done outstandingly well and continues to do outstandingly well because we are not Los Angeles. We are not New York City. We never were going to be any of those things. Ironically, this is one of the few things Dr. Levin was actually right about. He has been wrong about everything. He is the one who told us we would have 400 to 600 hospitalizations a day. He revised that to 200 to 400 a day. We still haven't reached that in one day. We're barely over 200 for the entire ordeal that you guys have put us through. We now have panicked over 51 total hospitalizations in a county with 8 hospitals. Can you people do math? Can you please do basic math and understand where we are on this? This is not a crisis. You, however, have created one. You, in an effort to try to prevent all death, when we've had 43 deaths, have now ended all relevant life. And you should all be ashamed of yourselves. And this will never be forgotten. Ever be forgotten. You will all be held accountable eventually, in this life or the next. You all better hope there is no hell, because when you die, that's where you're going. And guess what? You're not going to be dying of COVID either. Thank you.
Oh my God, that was like the best scene ever from the end of some movie. Who's that guy you and Taylor always like? From, Taylor does the voice. The Christmas on Miracle Street. Oh, it's a Wonderful Life.
Miracle on 34th Street.
That's something Jimmy Stewart would say at the end of one of those movies you guys like.
Oh, It's a Wonderful Life.
That was the best rant I've ever heard.
That was really good. That was top notch. Dr. Levin, he's the health director. At least he's a doctor. In L.A., they're shut down for the whole summer, and they got a former high school principal from JP. She's the health director. She has a master's degree or a PhD in, social work or something like that, or social activism or community organizing. And she's calling the shots. At least that nut they got in Ventura County, he appears to be a doctor, although maybe he's one of those PhD-type doctors. But that was great. 844-500-4242. Rocky, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Rocky.
Hey, Howie, that was awesome. I'm bald and the hair stood up on the back of my head. Hey, Howie, I want to throw this at you. You know what scares me is the losers that are destroying the country, the whole left, tearing down statues. None of these scumbags know the history of the country.
Right.
They don't have a clue. They don't care. But what scares me is, I don't know who said the pen is mightier than the sword, but people in Washington are doing the same thing to the country, except without the violence. No one's going to prison. How can Biden run for president when he is accused of rape and all the Ukraine and all the stuff, Obama, treason,
right,
this, that? How is he allowed to run for president?
You know, Judicial Watch, they're always, filing Freedom of Information Act requests for various government documents. They just got some documents on Hunter Biden, his crack-addled, whoremongering, alcoholic son. He took 411 trips on Air Force planes during the first 4.5 years of the Obama-Biden regime. 411, and he had Secret Service protection. Secret Service protection when he's out chasing hookers, when he's out, running into a men's room to buy coke, when he's going to rehab centers to get dried out. He's got all these. We should try to get Tom Fitton on to discuss that, as a matter of fact. Thanks for the call, Rocky. This is from Thomas Paine. Someone just texted this to me. This is a great sound cut. This is a great quote. So true. Society is produced by our wants and government our wickedness. The former promotes our happiness by positively uniting our affections, the latter by negatively restraining our vices. The one encourages intercourse, the other creates distinctions. The first is a patron, the last a punisher. That's Thomas Paine. It's from the revolutionary period. It's true. I mean, all the good, all the goods that are produced by society, all the advances, almost all of them come from private enterprise. And the most of the terrible miseries that are inflicted upon mankind come from government in one form or another. And that's what's so insane about these leftists that want to increase government power, because it's just going to increase misery. Look at Venezuela. Look at Cuba. Look at Cambodia. Look at the Soviet Union. Look at all the Warsaw Pact countries that are now free. Do you think they'd like to go back to communism? I don't think so. So we're the most successful society in human history, and they want to tear it down, and they want to destroy it, and they want to take away everyone's freedoms. Because why? Think it through. It doesn't make any sense. Why would you want to restrict freedom in any form? Charles, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Charles.
Yeah. Yes, I'm glad to be able to speak to you. What I'm, I have to say, I live in Arlington, Mass., and I have to say that I'm very discouraged. I'm just concerned about, you know, hearing about the polls and all that. Maybe I shouldn't pay attention to them so much. I just don't see how President Trump can win in November. I don't know. I'd like to see if you can throw some light on that. The first thing,
Charles, is turn off your TV set. That would be my first advice for you. I think you'd feel a lot better. Or just watch a few shows. Watch Newsmax, watch OAN, watch Fox, and don't watch all of Fox either. But I mean, you can't be watching the mainstream newscast. They're full of it, aren't they?
Yes, Ron, I wanted to mention one thing. I all these riots and burning of buildings, I compare that to the Red Guards in Red China under Mao in the 1960s. I mean, why, you know, shouldn't the president come out and just say, okay, we see these people doing this, why don't they take action? Is the president afraid? This morning I heard on another show that Trump is not doing enough. He's acting in effect quite weak on this.
Well, his hands are somewhat tied by politics. You know, if he moved into CHOP, we've talked about this before for the last week or so, because it seems rather obvious. If he moves into CHOP in Seattle and anybody's hurt, everybody's killed, it'll all be on him, and you'll have another situation where you have a martyr. I mean, even if the guy was, running around with an automatic weapon and shooting at the police or shooting at the military, they would make him into a martyr. And it would just, he has to deal. I mean, the media is an even greater threat and an even greater menace to Donald Trump and the silent majority, as I hope we still are, than the Democrats, because they're more effective than the Democrats. I think they are Democrats and they're just a wing of the party, but they're the most effective wing. And the thing is, I keep checking my email, and it's Xfinity, which is Comcast. And every time I check my email, I have to see a headline that, you know what it says? It's a picture of Donald Trump, and it's a nasty picture of him, like it always is. It says, Russia bounty plot. Like it's real. There is a plot, but it's a plot to plant this latest Russian hoax on Donald Trump. That's the plot. But if you're, you know, a low info voter, if you're, someone who's educated in a public or even a private, what's the difference? College in the last 10, 15 years, you probably don't know. You probably think it's really a plot by the Russians and Donald Trump. Thanks for the call, Charles. I mean that about cutting off the TV. Johnny, you're next with Howie Carr, except when I'm on it, of course. Go ahead, Johnny.
Yeah, Howie, without a doubt, the media is just dreadful. But I wanted to comment. The other day, up here, I don't know if you were around for the storms. You know, I'm in Walpole. We had about 4 inches of
rain.
Yeah,
no, we were driving back at the time. It was bad on the highway, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So Norwood, what they did, you know, because all with the social distancing, all the restaurants in downtown Norwood, they all had outdoor seating. I don't know if you saw the videos. It was like 3 feet of water running down, and all these chairs and barricades just floating down this. So not only are these people getting smoked because of this dimwit Charlie Baker, I mean, for these people in Norwood who vote for John Rogers, I mean, this guy's done zero for you. And have you heard anything? Is anyone going to back up these business owners who are losing money already? Now they had to buy outdoor seating. Now all their outdoor seating got washed down the street.
Like, I know. They all spend. You know what this has been great for? It's great for tents. You know, tent manufacturers and tent companies, because they all got the tents out in the by. It's been great for people to make picnic tables, because they all got the picnic tables out there. It's been great for people who have concrete blocks, because you got to put the concrete blocks in front of the picnic tables so that nobody in the parking lot can run into them. But you're right, Johnny. I mean, where are the state reps here? We're a Republican or Democrat saying, hey, this has gone on long enough. Let up on the people. You know, this is silly. This is not necessary. You know, if you're at risk, take precautions. We're sorry 8,000 people are dead. 5,000 of them died in your nursing homes, Charlie Parker. Your inept, corrupt Department of Public Health regulates those nursing homes. Why didn't you do anything about it? Was the DPH too busy still falsifying 38,000 tests, drug tests in the criminal cases? Were they too busy not regulating the New England compounding pharmacy in Framingham, where 70 people died, were poisoned because of state ineptitude? And now 5,000 people are dead in nursing homes because of the same thing, state ineptitude. And everybody in the Commonwealth has to pay the price because you didn't know what you were doing, because you killed all those veterans in Holyoke and in Chelsea at the homes you directly managed. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
Howie Carr. You can trust him. He's not like the others.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by the Barley House in Concord and Northampton, New Hampshire. Bringing people together for a great time and great food, including fresh ground burgers. Their amazing staff is determined to make your day better. Check out thebarleyhouse.com. What's the number one sign of a bad home security system? A home security system that's so complicated you never use it. This is exactly the type of security system SimpliSafe has spent a decade fighting against. They believe that simple is safer. SimpliSafe was designed to be easy to use while protecting your whole home 24/7. Order online with the click of a button. Open the box, place the sensors, plug it in, and your home is protected around the clock.
And Howie, I just want to say, as someone who just bought a new house, that a lot of people won't be coming to your house anytime soon because of the new rules set in place for quarantine. So SimpliSafe is awesome because it is easy. You can do it all yourself. You do not need to be an electrician, or you don't need to even be really good with technology.
SimpliSafe was named Best Overall Home Security of 2020 by U.S. News and World Report, and their 24/7 professional monitoring and emergency dispatch starts at just 50 cents a day. Head to SimpliSafeHowie.com and get free shipping and a 60-day money-back guarantee. That's SimpliSafeHowie.com to make sure they know that our show sent you.
He might not be flashy, but he's there when it counts. Here's 1 minute of Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell.
For the first time in my memory, I agree with Nancy Pelosi. I am indeed the Grim Reaper when it comes to the socialist agenda that they've been ginning up over in the House.
You watch the fight, you watch the tactics, but here's what I want to tell you. In the very near future, Judge Kavanaugh will be on the United States Supreme Court.
Noted with great interest the Green New Deal. And we're going to be voting on that in the Senate. We'll give everybody an opportunity to go on record and see how they feel about the Green New Deal.
Well, first on the impartiality issue, do you think Chuck Schumer is impartial? Do you think Elizabeth Warren is impartial?
No.
Bernie Sanders is impartial? So let's quit the charade. This is a political exercise. Nobody is supposed to be guilty until proven innocent in the United States of America. Look, we're at an impasse. We can't do anything until the speaker sends the papers over. So everybody enjoy the holidays.
We all shop online, and now you could do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey
Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Well, should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I let him have a little bit more? Sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
When I raise money... Excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty. Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better.
If I may ask one other question, Mr. President, are you worried...
That's enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? Do you think I'm creating something? Ask these incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons, because your question is a very political question, because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
This is Paul in North Andover, Mass.
This is Luana in Lexington, Massachusetts.
This is Lauren in Augusta, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
207 says, I'm a Maine resident. My girlfriend and I have been traveling around the state to support the economy. This weekend in Bar Harbor, 85% of the lodging places were closed. Do you blame them? I mean, with that 14-day quarantine, they arrested a Maine guy in Hawaii today or yesterday. He flew out there, I guess, for a vacation, and you have to quarantine in your hotel room for 14 days. I'm not kidding. I just read the story online, and he decided to go for a walk. He didn't want to be locked up for 14 days. I don't know what the hell he went there for in the first place, but he was arrested. He was arrested. So anyway, he says, the guy from Maine who was at Bar Harbor, we went on a sailboat that has a capacity of 150 people, and on a Saturday departure at 2 p.m., had 8 people at the end of June when it was 80 degrees. It's just, it's bad. 508 says, God help Ken's. Ken's is in better shape than most places. Ken's is a place, my favorite seafood restaurant in Scarborough. Ken's was always an outdoor place. They only added the indoor seating maybe, I don't know, 20, 25 years ago. They got that huge parking lot and that outside dining area, which was always where people ate. So they're in better shape than most places, that's for sure. And I hope Dave Wilcox stays in good shape because they employ a lot of people. I wish everybody were open everywhere. John, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, John.
Thanks, Howie. Just wanted to say that what's going on in Seattle, it's a great commercial for the coming events, like a preview of the future, what's going to happen with if the Democrats were ever to win.
I know, and I think Trump knows that too, don't you? I mean, in a way, this is the best advertising he could get, isn't it?
It's free. He doesn't even have to pay for it. It's like it's on display. Let it go. What's all the shootings there? That's all Democrat fault. It's all just completely neglecting American citizens under attack. It's a form of terrorism. They're allowing it to happen. Just like the terrorism in Boston, that's what's going on. Black Lives Matter, that group, that BLM group, I'm sorry, they're a terrorist organization. That's what we're seeing, our own citizens terrorized under the mask of racism. They're being terrorized.
Don't forget Antifa. Don't forget Antifa. And it's, when the Pew Research Center did a study saying that that only 16% of the people in Black Lives Matter were black, 47% were white, and the other sorted groups, the remaining percentages. But it's a real mess, and the Democrats in Washington State, in New York State, in Illinois, in Michigan, they're not doing anything about it. I'm Howie Carr. Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Usually we just brush it off or blame ourselves, saying things like, I lost my mojo. Or we avoid it altogether with excuses like, I had a long day at work. Or, sorry, honey, I'm just not feeling it. But with Roman, it is easy to talk about. With a real doctor who can prescribe real medication, it's simple, safe, and totally discreet. With Roman, you can get a free online evaluation and ongoing care for erectile dysfunction, all from the comfort and privacy of your own home. The doctor will work with you to find the best treatment plan. If medication is appropriate, Roman will ship it to you with free two-day shipping. Getting started is simple. Just go to GetRoman.com/Howie and complete an online visit. Erectile dysfunction used to be tough to tackle, but now there's Roman. Complete an online visit today to connect with a doctor and take care of it. Just go to GetRoman.com/Howie to get a free online visit and free two-day shipping. That's GetRoman.com/Howie for a free visit to get started. GetRoman.com/Howie.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators?
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm working for you.
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
Here's Donald Trump Jr. proving once and for all the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
They hate Trump more than they love America. For them to try to take a pandemic and seemingly hope that it comes here and kills millions of people so that they could end Donald Trump's streak of winning. I don't know if this is coronavirus or Trump derangement syndrome, but these people are infected badly.
To make this guy into a religious scholar, that's like saying Jeffrey Dahmer is a purveyor of organic and fine exotic meats. Adam Schiff is basically the Jussie Smollett of Congress on steroids.
Children are off limits. Remember this one? If 13-year-old Barron Trump is not off limits, Hunter Biden sure as is not off limits.
Because my name is Trump, if I took $1.5 from China, not $1.5 billion like Hunter, their heads would explode.
Who is your favorite Democrat? Go ahead.
Mitt Romney is my favorite Democrat. How about that?
Please, Lord, in my next life, make me a leftist so I can say anything and get away with it.
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.